Welcome back, everyone. This is Dirch, and it's time for the Sal Skill and Gear Guide. I have with me here Chuck80. Chuck, if you want to say hi to everyone.
Hi, everyone.
If you guys don't know Chuck, I talked about him in my Community Badass video a while ago. He is one of my favorite Sal players. But not only Sal stuff, he has maintained a lot of splash guides, critical hit guides, and he's mostly well known for coming up with the deputy build. But besides that, Chuck and Slidgem, like, you guys really broke down a lot of like the offhand stuff, the Sal mechanics, figured out all that stuff. So when a lot of you in the audience, you guys see a lot of people on YouTube and Twitch like doing this cool stuff with Sal, a lot of that's possible because of the groundwork Chuck and Slidgem laid. So that's enough of me kissing Chuck's ass to start with.
Well, actually, most of it is Slidgem's work. I just,
he's the sheriff and you're the deputy.
Yeah, basically.
But also one of my favorite, but I often kind of shit on Sal. I've been known to do that once or twice, but your reasoning for being a fan of Sal is the only one that kind of makes me stop and think. Do you mind just telling everyone quick why you love Sal? See if it's the same thing I've heard you say before.
Yeah, the thing with Sal is that most people kind of refer to him as easy mode, like, and I kind of have to agree with that on one hand, because ease. How do I put this? Actually playing him, like holding the controller or the mouse, yes, it is very easy. But it's only easy when you have, like, a good build going. Because, I don't know how to explain this. You don't really play Sal. You kind of build one and then let it loose. If that makes sense.
Yeah.
I mean, you kind of pick your gear and you pick your skills carefully and then go to town with it. And if you're dying all the time or running out of ammo or having those long downtimes with reloads and stuff like that, it's because your build's not quite good enough. But when you get it right, it's just basically hold down both triggers and just look at what you want dead. but to get to that point, it's a lot of tweaking and micromanaging. But once it's done, builds can be shared easily. So most people say, yeah, Sal's easy mode. They just picked a build that someone else did. If they had to come up with their own build, I don't think they would say that Sal is easy mode. So That's the crux with him. The thing that's hard with Sal is coming up with builds. It's in the details.
Yeah, there was a forum post when we were talking about, I don't know if it was me or you, a bunch of other people, but I think your answer was, I love Sal because it's complicated mechanics.
And yeah, like, exactly.
That's pretty much what you were saying there. It's like, the all the offhand stuff you can do and all the, like, the different interactions and what procs with what, and he's exactly. An easy character to play, most, but he's a complex character mechanics wise and that's cool.
Yeah, most of what Sal does is kind of like passive, so it's got to chain with one another seamlessly while the player does virtually nothing. With Maya, you phase lock and then throw the grenade and then aim your scorn at that distance and ADS to the head to get crits. And there's a lot of, it's an involved process. With Sal, once the build is done, it's basically just a killing machine that you turn on.
See, I think Maya mode is kind of easy. It's zero that challenges me. But
I use Maya as an example because that's what most of your subs are familiar with. But zero is kind of the antithesis of Sal. You can pretty much do any kind of build with zero as long as it's not like completely moronic, and it'll be fine if you're a good player. And And even if you have a good build, if you suck at playing Zero, you'll suck. Yep. Your build will not save you. Sal is the opposite of that. So that's anyone can play Sal if they have a good build.
All right. I think that's a good place to start then. So let's start looking at skill trees. Is there one you want to start with?
Let's do from left to right, like you all always right, do. All right. That's fine with me.
So before we start on a skill tree, we have to talk about Gunzerking itself. So Gunzerking is his action skill. You press your action skill to draw a second gun and go nuts. I love the description. While Gunzerking, you instantly regen 50% of your maximum health, gain damage reduction against enemy attacks, and constantly regen health and ammo. It does not regenerate rockets, which is a good thing. So Gunzerking, like a lot of action skills, the problem I had with it starting playing this game, same thing I kind of had with Nisha to a point and Athena a little bit, is I love to ADS, I love to aim, I love to carefully place my shots. And just that always having the hip fire kind of bothers me. You know, Nisha, they kind of fixed that. Athena still had that issue, but she had her melee jumping around to get so close it didn't matter as much to me. But that was my one drawback with it. But the idea of just holding down two guns and going nuts, I think, is cool as fuck.
Yeah, it's not for everyone. I understand that. Yeah. But it's something that's completely different too. It's just another way of seeing the game.
Do you think it's done better in the pre-sequel of Nisha's, where it's only a duplicate of the gun, where she can't do different guns, or would you prefer Sal's way?
It's much more reasonable in the pre-sequel. I mean, it's made in the way to make sure there's no abuse. Though it's a bit weird because you run out of ammo so fast with one to reach of you. So so it's
those don't have the biggest ammo pool. So Sal was my first character I played in this game. Not a lot of people know that, and I picked him because I loved Lilith in Borderlands 1. And again, a lot of people don't think that makes sense, but one thing I love with Lilith in Borderlands 1, I could just like pop my phase lock, run headfirst into enemies, and then light them up with an SMG. And just kind of like charging guns blazing. And I had fun doing that. And I thought Sal's playstyle would mimic that a lot by popping Gunzerkering and just charge headfirst in the enemies and being tanky. But I just couldn't get over, just never felt right to me.
Yeah.
So
yeah, it's a bit different. But maybe it's possible that, I don't know, you changed as a player. As you played more Borderlands, your taste got refined a bit.
Oh, without a doubt. I was all body shots when I started playing Borderlands.
Yeah. Oh, if you can't handle doing mostly body shots, then no, Sal isn't for you. Because aiming with him is like it's a non-existent thing.
Yep. So yeah, let's start gun lust here. Locked and loaded. Reloading your guns increases fire rate for a short time, 25%. Yeah, I mean, 25% is a pretty big bonus. Is the short time same as a kill skill?
It's about, 5 or 6 seconds. I think it's a bit shorter than a kill skill, but It really, on average, it really doesn't matter, because Sal usually gets so much fire rate going that whatever gun you're holding will be empty way before the bonus runs out.
Yeah, that's fair enough. I thought you were going to say it doesn't matter because he has so many fire rate boost other places, but 25% is pretty big.
But as a tier one skill, that's pretty good.
All right. Quick draw increases weapon swap speed and critical hit damage with all gun types. At 5 out of 5, swap speed's 35%, critical hit 10. 10% is really low for critical hit bonus there.
Yeah. The thing with that skill is I usually take it, but not because it's good, but because the next tier is is pretty niche or bad, depending on what you're using. If I'm using pistol, I'll go down with I'm your Huckleberry. But otherwise, quick draw is better than all I need to
swap. So swap speed's a fairly big deal with sail, though, because a lot of sail builds, you're kind of swapping around different guns. You know, you want to be able to swap from Grog to Ladyfist pretty quickly.
Yeah, with some of these, yes, but you mentioned probably the only example where swap speed would be important with Sal, because most people who swap guns swap from, let's say, slag gun to their normal DPS gun. Mm-hmm. Well, Sal doesn't have to do that. The only reason that you would want to swap a gun would be to get to a Grog and back, and pistols have the fastest swap speed in the game already. Yeah. So, and if you're using pistols, you're probably using your Urkelberry anyway.
Yeah, good point.
So I usually take it, but it's not because it's good. It's because it's better than the next tier.
I always forget to silence my phone before I start recording. I don't know if you just heard it go off. All right.
Yeah.
Got that thing out of the way.
I'll silence mine.
So yeah, it's sometimes just a better option, but not a fantastic skill, but not a bad one.
No, it's pretty average.
On your Huckleberry, then, increases gun damage and reload speed with pistols. Pistol damage 15%, pistol reload speed 15%. I think these buffs should have been a little bit bigger. It's hard to say Sal's buff is too small, but if it's only pistols, 15%.
It's a small buff.
Yeah, and pistols don't really need a reload speed buff at all. Especially, Sal's got a bunch of ways to either other ways to increase reload speed, I believe. And pistols have quick reload speed. Or you can make them last really long with a bunch of his other skills. Yeah, it doesn't seem like it's great for making you want to play pistols.
It's not great, but if you go through all Sal's skills, additive gun damage bonuses are very few and far between. There's I'm your Huckleberry, there's Divergent Likeness, and Just Got Real, and Keeping Piping Hot, and that's pretty much it.
And you do want to stack some of those to get more out of Money Shot and other things.
Yeah, I mean, it's gun damages on Sal, there's not a whole lot of them, so if you're using pistol, that 15% is better than nothing, I'd say.
Yeah. You can finish.
Oh, no, it's fine. It's not great, but if you're using pistols, pick this one.
All right. Next is All I Need Is One. Swapping weapons causes your next shot fired to deal additional damage. I really don't like this that much.
Me neither.
I mean, the bonus damage at 40% of 5 out of 5 is good, and the fact that you can probably boost it with a comm is even better, but if you're constantly swapping to get that one shot of damage, you're kind of lowering your DPS by swapping to get that one shot of damage. I guess it's good for setting up like no-kill, like overkill.
Even then. I've tried to include it in some of my builds and try to do a build centered around autoloader. So just like get a pair of guns and shoot until I kill something that would reload my other guns, and then go back to, and use All I Need Is One as much as possible. And it just, I've never found a way to make this skill useful.
All right.
And I don't think anyone has.
No, I've never seen anyone really abuse it or really do that. If it was for a short duration, that'd be different.
That would be awesome. But if it was like as long as Locked and Loaded or Kill Skill, for example, then there would be merits to having a build centered around Quick Draw, All I Need Is One, and Auto Loader. That would make a lot of sense. But as it is...
Yeah, I see what you mean. That tier 2 is kind of not the greatest.
Yeah. So that's why I like Quick Draw in most of my builds. Because, yeah, that tier is If you're not using pistols, then that tier is useless.
Kind of wasted, yep. So next we got Divergent Likeness. When gunzerking with two guns of the same type, you deal bonus damage. When gunzerking with two different guns, you gain bonus accuracy. Now, typically, a lot of guns in Borderlands, I think their accuracy outside of shotguns is too high, like I talked about with the SMG assault rifles. I mean, that was, you actually brought up that point. But on this one, because Sal is hip firing, I kind of do like that. Because hip firing is when you need the accuracy.
Yeah, it helps a bit on minimum accuracy. That is before recoils comes into the equation. The thing with Sal is you're rarely at minimum accuracy.
Yeah.
Either you get a gun that's got the Hyperion gimmick, or a gun with a good max accuracy, or you get closer. I like this one for in two scenarios. If you're using a quad or any other very inaccurate gun, mm-hmm. to kind of tighten that spread a bit and make it usable, or for the damage boost.
And the damage again, boost is legit at 30% always on.
Yeah.
So if you're doing a pistol build,
one of the best Sal has.
Yeah. You're sitting with 45% if you're doing a pistol build between this and Huckleberry. That's solid.
That's starting to get into good value territory here.
Yeah. And it's 10 points for 45, but 45 always on, that's really strong.
Mm. Plus, if you want to get down that tree, you have to pick some of these skills anyways, so yep. it's not like those 10 points are wasted going yep. down there.
Next, the game changer of autoloader. Killing an enemy instantly reloads all your guns that you have equipped that are not currently in your hands. Swapping guns after autoloader has reloaded a gun triggers locked and loaded.
I like this one. It's not exceptional, but I've seen people get good use out of it. Like just having two sets of powerful weapons and just swapping between one and the others so as to not have to ever reload. But the way I prefer to use it is to reload my Fight for Your Life rocket launcher, basically.
Okay.
If I spend a point in that skill, I can use my main guns, and whenever I go down, I can swap to my rocket launcher, and it's always full.
That's a damn good point. I mean, whenever I toy around with Sal builds, I always just throw one in here because it's 1 point, and why not? What it does is pretty good. And the fact that it triggers locked and loaded is kind of a big deal, I think. Mm-hmm. So when you do swap, you've got that fire rate.
Yeah. If you're based on... if you have build that's based on... I've seen a guy not too long ago who was running a chopper in one hand and... a sledge shotgun in the other, and swap to something just as ludicrous in his two other gun slots, and mostly these guns have terrible reload speed. So he just like killed something, then swapped.
Yep.
And yeah, it worked pretty well.
So next up, we have the infamous money shot. 5 points in this. Gives you, I gotta get a comp that doesn't boost it. Money shot, the last round fire from your magazine deals massively increased damage. Guns with a small magazine receive a smaller bonus. The skill works with all weapon types. The last round of your magazine deals up to 400% extra damage. The minimum mag size for a full bonus is 10. And that 400% is not added, it's actually 12, okay.
It's actually 12, and the bonus scales, I don't have the numbers in front of me, but I think it's over 1,000%.
And, yeah, the fact that it's multiplicative is kind of the dumb thing here, because that just gets so big. If it was additive, it would still be a ridiculously good skill, but it wouldn't be quite as powerful. Now, a lot of people say this is why Sal is broken, and I really disagree. I don't think this is a broken skill. I think this combined with like 10 other things is kind of broken, but Money Shot on itself, I don't think is broken.
Yeah, there are a few things in that game that, oh, and this works with Money Shot, and this too works with Money Shot. Mm-hmm. So, and all of these things like are kind of using, are kind of riding Money Shot to a ludicrous amount of damage, but in itself, Money Shot isn't broken. It's strong. It is very strong, but typically you're supposed to use it with a gun that has a mag size of 10 or 12. And so getting to that last shot is not, it's not a common occurrence, or you would have to time yourself perfectly to really benefit from it. Mm-hmm. What breaks it is the rocket launcher Pimpernel build. You get Money Shot on all of your shots.
Yep.
On the Deputy Sal, you get Money Shot on every other shot. And with Inconceivable, when those Money Shot chains, you get like 10, 12, 15 in a row. So now,
I've heard the argument. It was from Nopo. You know Nopo.
Yeah.
He said Inconceivable doesn't, because for every time you get that chain, you also take longer to get to those shots as well. So on average, Inconceivable balances out where it doesn't help Money Shot one way or the other.
It's, I kind of disagree with that. The thing is, yeah, it takes longer for you to get to that Money Shot, but it's,
when it chains.
Yeah. The thing is, like, instead, let's say you have a gun with a mag size of 12, mm-hmm. okay? So, usually you would get a Money Shot every 12 shots.
Yeah.
Now, assuming Inconceivable is running at all times, let's say you don't have a shield. Mm-hmm. So, basically, it should go off 50% of the time. So, your theoretical magazine size would be something like 24 now instead of 12. So it would take twice as long, but you would get twice as many Money Shots. But the thing is, when it chains, you get 12, 15 in a row. So it doesn't work like that. Some Inconceivable will trigger, and then it will be active for like 2 or 3 seconds. It's not, it doesn't calculate its chance on every shot. It calculates them on, I don't know exactly, but every 2 seconds or something.
Oh, okay. So you can get multiple shots off while it's going.
Yeah. When it goes off, it doesn't save you one shot. It saves you all of your shots for X seconds.
And Sal can go crazy with fire rate.
Exactly. And it would be for mobbing. It is pretty balanced, because usually when you're using it, getting one Money Shot or 15 on a bandit doesn't change anything.
Yeah,
but on a boss, if you get those chains, then it's a massive amount of damage. Yeah, so it's not Money Shot that's broken. It's just that so many things with Sal are broken, and they're all riding Money Shot.
Yep, it's a good way to look at it. Next we have Lay Waste. Lay Waste is a kill skill. Killing an enemy increases fire rate and critical hit damage with all guns for a short while. 40% fire rate, 25% critical hit damage. For a kill skill that's in tier 4, I really wish that critical hit damage would have been a little bit higher. But 40% fire rate's pretty damn high.
And the best thing about this one is that it's on... I'd say the two best, well, people will say that the Monk is the best, but the Legendary Gunzerker and the Legendary Hoarder are two of my favorite comms, and both of these boost Lay Waste.
Yeah, and 80% fire rate on kill skill is damn worth it.
Yes, it is. It's not spectacular as a skill. It doesn't do anything special. I mean, it's a flat bonus to fire rate and crit bonus on a kill skill, but you know, it's kind of solid.
I would love to have something like this on Maya.
Yeah, it's pretty good, but there's I don't have much to say about this one. But
that's fair enough. Yeah, I mean, a lot of sale builds aren't critting all the time, but when you do go with a build that is critting more often, like your deputy build that, you know, you definitely want to aim for those crits with the shotguns, definitely helps.
Yeah, the thing with sale with crits is they're not something you do. They're things that happen.
All right. That's a fair point. I guess every time I try to do a sale build, I try to crit all the time. Down, not out. This is...
God, you can't I wish I had this on my this.
Own. Yeah. For one point, you can Gunzerk well and fight for your life.
I mean, it's worth it going down the Gunless Tree just so that's skill.
Yeah. Without a doubt. Because we all go in to fight for your life a few times. I've gone on that rant on every video. It's like, get over yourselves, assholes. You also go in to fight for your life.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's ridiculous that he can do that and just get out. I would, again, if I could keep phase lock when Maya goes to fight for her life or phase lock in it, I would love that.
Yeah.
Yeah, nothing else to say about that one. I guess it's pretty simple.
It's just a must have. There's get this one.
Yep. Keep it piping hot. While Gunzerking is in the process of cooling down, you gain bonus gun damage, melee damage, and grenade damage, which is very cool.
It's pretty good. The thing that sets the skill apart is that when we go down the Rampage Tree, we'll get to get some at some point.
Mm-hmm.
And get some does activate keeping piping hot when it goes off. So you can actually benefit from this skill while you're Gunzerking.
I did not know that. See, this is why I have Chuck here, people. I would not have known that, and you would have corrected me in the comments, and I'd have to do a correction video, but now we got it right.
Also, the gun damage bonus, I should have done these for... God damn it. I should have done this with all the skills, because some of these apply to the offhand, and some don't. And keeping piping hot is a good example. The gun damage bonus only applies to your main hand.
Okay.
But the grenade damage applies to either hand.
Which is, again, the complexities of Sal. What applies to the offhand or not is always very interesting. Like Money Shot does.
Money Shot does. I'll just do a quick roundup of what we've done so far. Okay. Luck and Loaded works. Quick Draw works. I'm Your Huckleberry doesn't. So that it sucks. Only applies to your main hand. Lay Waste works on your offhand for the crit bonus, but not for the fire rate bonus.
And what about Divergent Likeness?
Divergent Likeness. Let me get to my notes. Yes, it does.
Okay.
Yes, it does work.
So that's cool. So you can get this well Gunzerking.
Yep. Get some, kind of starts your cooldown for 3 seconds every time you shoot an enemy.
For those three seconds,
you're considered to be in cooldown, so keep it by not does activates at that point.
And being able to boost grenade damage is kind of a big deal, because grenade damage, if you applies to a lot of guns with splash damage, especially Torg guns, not all of them, but a lot of them, and yeah. So that's kind of a big deal. Because I think this is his only skill to boost grenade damage, right?
It is. Yep.
Yeah. And also, he can chuck 2 grenades at once with certain skills, which this also makes those better.
All in all, pretty good skill. If you intend to go down to get no kill like overkill, you can do much worse. That's pretty much it.
Speaking of no-kill like overkill, this is pretty awesome. I love this. Killing an enemy grants bonus damage to your next shot equal to the excess damage you dealt to the enemy you just killed. So, before I let you loose on this, I did a video a while back ago, like, Ultimate Vault Hunter mode is easier with a smarter build. encouraging people doing like Maya builds, the Beehawking builds, don't go and put 10 out of 10 and all of her DPS skills boosted by that comm and wear a bee and wear the cat comm and use a sandhawk, because you're just doing overkill damage that just goes into air. And you'd be better off doing 1 out of 5 in those skills, so you get 6 out of 5, and using those for survival, because you're just wasting those 4 skill points on all those skills. But no kill like overkill, that kind of, that changes.
You do want to get that overkill damage there.
Yeah. And that's fun. Like, Krieg has that with Blood Explosion as well. I think they're the only two characters that get anything out of overkill damage.
Yep. As far as I know, yeah.
And it is it's a multiplicative, like Money Shot, so it really cranks your damage up.
There's a lot of misconception about that skill, though, onto how does it work. It's not the overkill damage that you did that gets applied to your next shots. It's it's percentage based on the total health of the enemy you just killed.
Is this up to like 480% or something like that?
It's 400% is the cap. So let's say you have an enemy that has 10 health left. Mm-hmm. Okay, he's almost dead, and you do 1,000,000 damage to him. So you have about 1,000,000 damage of overkill, mm-hmm. right?
Yep.
That now this gets compared to the total health of the enemy when it, like, the max health of that enemy, and that percentage is applied to your next shots. So it's not only how much damage you've dealt in excess of what was left, but it's comparative to the total health of the enemy. So the weaker the enemy is, the bigger the bonus is. If you kill an UBA with that, even if you deal a lot of overkill damage, you might not get a big bonus because you...
Their overall health is so big.
Exactly.
Okay. But so one thing I love about no kill like overkill is the synergy with Money Shot. Because Money Shot, you'll get that one really big shot. You'll probably get that maximum overkill because Money Shot's so huge. And then your next shot following Money Shot, chances are you're going to have no kill like overkill.
You're going to have that. You're going to have that 500, that 400% bonus, pretty much guaranteed. Yep. Though it relies on you being able to control when you get that Money Shot.
Yeah.
Like, if you kill your enemy with the second to last bullet, then you're not getting anything. Mm-hmm. So it works well with a deputy build because you do have the control over that last shot.
And you only have 2 shots. So it's Money Shot, no kill, like overkill. Money Shot, no kill, like overkill.
Yeah, exactly.
If you're one-shotting everything.
Yeah, your odds of getting that big number are much higher with a deputy build than the average cell build.
Yep. Is there anything else with the Gunlust Tree then?
Other than to say that, I mean, this tree is pretty much about DPS mostly. All these are fire rate buffs or damage buffs, and you won't see many of these in the 2 other trees. So that's where the biggest part of Sal's damage output comes from, which means that in normal and true old hunter mode, it's pretty much overkill. You don't need to go into that tree at all, but for UVHM, it's pretty much a given.
Okay. Then the next tree, I just respect while you're talking, so I didn't have to cut out to do that. Rampage. So we actually just talked about Inconceivable a bunch in that last one, but your shots have a chance to not consume ammo, the lower your health and shields, the greater chance of the free shot, chance up to 50%. So the deal with this is if you're wearing the Rough Rider, your shields are depleted and you get that full bonus, right? You don't have to have health missing to get the full bonus.
No, it triggers once you have no shield or lower. The thing is with Sal, you don't really need the Rough Rider. It's just more reliable because, well, typical playstyle with Sal is get in their face. Yep. So usually you get your shield for like the first 2 or 3 seconds, and then you're on health. So this skill, it's about as good as tier one skills come in that game, in franchise, I would say, except for those one pointer that you have to take, like anarchy or things like
Maelstrom. Yeah.
You'd be hard pressed to find a tier one skill on any character that's as good as this.
I will combat best foot forward with Jack, which makes him almost unkillable. Or makes him be able to like permanently have Jacks out. Or pretty close good to point. It. But yeah, okay, there's very few that good.
Yeah.
I'm like, I can think of
one. When in normal mode, this thing gets a lot out of your limited ammo supply. And as you get higher in levels, it just never stops being good.
Yeah, and that's a great point in normal mode. Like, it's not taking ammo out of your ammo pool to add them to your magazine like the Butcher. This is giving you free shots.
Yeah,
and basically. And Sal can crank fire rate, and this is ammo mitigation. And that's the thing that Nisha is missing in the pre-sequel, is ammo mitigation.
Totally. That's one of the 2, 3, 4 things that Sal has that makes him a much better bullet hose than Nisha is. He's not as fast as she is, but like he can do this for more than 2 minutes.
Yeah. But also, I mean, it's pretty much a 50% magazine increase size, essentially. And 50% magazine size is also a big deal. So, yeah, this is a crazy good skill. Next, you have Fill to the Brim. Increases your magazine size with all weapon types. Also increases your ammo carrying capacity with all ammo types. So before I dig into this, when people say switch out your comm after you respec, the only skills that really apply to that are ones that increase your ammo capacities. And this is one of them. So this accent's ability to increase your grenade size, but most damage skills that doesn't apply to, it's to skills like this.
Yeah. It's, I don't have much to say about this one. It's pretty good. It's great when you're starting normal Vault Hunter mode for the extra ammo. Otherwise, the mag size increase is nice. It's not as good as, say, Maya's Foresight, but because there's no real speed involved. Yeah, as far as tier one skill go, they're pretty good. It's pretty solid. Good.
Yep.
Yeah.
But yeah, the extra ammo carrying capacity, though, that 50% with all guns, that's not nothing.
The thing with Sal is he doesn't need that.
Yeah, good point.
Between conceivable 5 shots or 6, the Gunzer King ammo regen.
Zero would have loved that on snipers.
Yeah, but on Sal, it's unneeded.
Okay. Next tier, all in the reflexes, increases reload speed and melee damage. So, time for my melee damage rant. I know, Sal, you can do your melee damage build, but I still think totally it's kind of niche. And, yeah, between like this and keep it piping hot, like, he's not a melee character. Let's just embrace the Gunzerking and do less melee.
Yeah, I agree 100% with you. If you're doing a Salvador melee build, you're doing it because of Fistful of Hurt and the ability to hold 2 rapiers at the same time, not because you get a 20% by spending 5 points in that.
Yeah.
It's pointless.
Yeah. The reload speed is nice, but it would have been better with a different other buff. You know, reload a mag or like Foresight, or reload in fire rate, or reload in accuracy, or reload in anything.
It's one of those nondescript, gives a bonus to 2 different basic things that almost every character
always
has.
They always throw melee in those.
Yeah, there's always one of them that has melee bonus. It's, yeah,
Axon's got it, Maya's got it, like everyone's got this.
I guess it's because it's pretty easy to design that way.
Yeah. But if in Borderlands 3, if they do a dedicated melee weapon slot, like grenade slot, then these would have a place. But as it stands, I think it was kind of not the greatest. Especially the way the damage doesn't scale well.
I'd rather have skills like Nisha's third degree. Gets 20% per point per stack. Mm-hmm. That lets you do kind of a hybrid build.
Yeah.
Just rub 5 points into that, and you can have, with the right comm, you can have like nearly, 200% or more just by spending 5 points in there. Yeah. That enables a melee build or hybrid build, but this alone doesn't do anything. It's just, if you want to do a melee build, you have to spend 5 points in that because, 20% melee bonus damage. So it's kind of a skill tax.
Yep. Next, lasts longer. Increases the duration of Gunzerking by 15 seconds.
Gunzerking's good. So longer Gunzerking's good,
also,
too.
The longer it is, the better chance of...
Yeah, you have more chance to activate Get Some. You have more opportunities to activate Yippee-ki-yay.
Yeah.
So your odds of being able to perma-Gunzerk are increased.
Much higher. Or your downtime is so much lower.
Yeah.
Even if you don't get the permanent, you might only be out of it for like 3 seconds.
It's kind of those synergy skills. Like if you don't have Get Some, Last Longer's, it's good, but it's not exceptional. Yeah. And Get Some without Last Longer will get you about a quarter or a third of your gun of your of your cooldown, so it's not much better than a cooldown bonus rate. But the two together can work to, like, they multiply each other.
Yep.
In efficiency.
So next, another cooldown, I'm ready already, increases the cooldown rate of Gunzerking ability 25%. So I've been told that this is kind of wasted because of things like Get Some and Last Longer, that this doesn't really help
it
you
is.
Out.
It is a bit wasted. If you're doing a pure rocket launcher build, because rocket launchers and other pure splash weapon don't activate Get Some, then it's worth it. And it's also worth it when you're running the peak, because the peak has those weird downtimes.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because, like, you kill a bunch of enemies, and then the next bunch start digistructing, but it takes a while. And during that time, you can't activate Get Some, so you might get stuck out of Gunzerk for a while. So it's kind of useful in the peak. And with rocket launcher builds. But otherwise, the thing is, you properly built Sal will get most of its cooldown from Get Some. And Get Some, the cooldown provided by Get Some is not affected by cooldown rate bonuses. So if you, let's say you just have 5 out of 5 in Last Longer, Yippee-ki-yay, and Get Some, typically, you'll be able to get like 3/4 of your cooldown. So there'll be like, I don't know, 10 seconds left to your cooldown, and you're still getting the Get Some bonus even when you're not in Gunzerking. So the bonus would apply only to about 6, 7, 8 seconds, and the 25% bonus. So maybe you'll save 2 seconds on your total.
Which
for
is
5 points.
Yeah, so you mentioned rocket launchers. Is that all pure splash? So if you're doing, let's say, a slow hand build, which would be something I might be interested in, I'm already would be good for that.
The slow, if I remember correctly, the slow hand does activate Get Some. It's one of those.
Okay, so it's mainly like it's a certain type of splash damage. That does
It's kind of those things that
they need to simplify
that,
splash damage.
it's weird. It's kind of those skills that like that activate the Krieg's bloodbath. It's some do, some don't.
Yep.
Well, it's the same with Get Some.
Yeah, there's at least 3 types of splash damage in the game. There really should be 1, maybe 2. And there might even be more than 3 types. We'd never be able to confirm that.
No, it's much too complicated.
Yes. All right, so steady as she goes. Reduces recoil with both guns while Gunzerking. Additionally, each shot that hits an enemy has a chance to improve your accuracy with both guns. Recoil reduction, 80%. Chance to improve accuracy, 30%. I'm going to start here. I hate to name names and that stuff, but people say it anyway. So, like, Baru did a video saying this skill is bad because if you're using Hyperion guns, it makes them a wild, unusable mess. I challenge that.
I kind of agree with you on that, because saying that a skill is
bad... I'm shooting the lady fist as you work. Say this.
Saying that a skill is bad because it doesn't really work with one type of guns is... I mean, is I'm Your Huckleberry a bad skill because it only works with pistols? No, it's a good skill that only works with pistols. So if you're using pistols, take it. If you're not using pistols, you don't take it. Well, it's the same with Steady As She Goes. If you're using Hyperion weapons, don't take it.
But even with Hyperion weapons, it's not that terrible.
It's not that bad. It's just, if you're mainly using Hyperion weapon, I wouldn't pick this skill because it's detrimental. But if you're
gonna swap to a lady fist occasionally, it's not gonna hurt you.
Yeah, how can I say this? If half of my loadout was Hyperion weapons, I would still take it. Because it makes Hyperion weapon less good at what they do, but it makes everything else so much better.
Mm-hmm. Like, I just shot a butcher, and I got to max accuracy with this skill in basically, I think, 2 shots.
Yeah.
With a Hyperion shotgun, so... You know, if you're using the interface or lady fist, some of these guns occasionally, it doesn't make them a terrible mess. If you're doing a Hyperion only build, yeah, sure, it's not going to help you, so don't grab it. But if you're going to occasionally use some Hyperion guns, you don't have to skip the skill.
Yeah, and if you're using anything else,
it's a massive deal.
80% recoil reduction is just awesome.
Yep. So one of the few like Sal builds I've ever played with myself was doing Becca builds with him. And this is a big deal in that build.
Yeah. For a guy that can't ADS at all, that recoil reduction and the chance to improve accuracy is also pretty good, especially with fast-firing weapons.
Yeah, so like, I just always like to fight those misconceptions out there.
Yeah, it's a very good skill. Just it doesn't really work with Hyperion weapons, so if that's what you're using, don't use it. But otherwise... It's a very good skill.
Yep. Next is 5 shots or 6. So, kill skill again. Killing an enemy causes every shot fired to have a chance to add ammunition to the magazine instead of expending ammunition. So, this is free ammo again, right? This doesn't take it from your ammo pool and put it in your mag. It just adds bullets to your mag from thin air.
It does. How it works exactly... is that it will, mechanically speaking, it will remove one bullet from the ammo expenditure. So if your gun is using 6 ammo per shot, like a DPU, we'll get it that down to 5, and then it will add an additional bullet to your magazine. So functionally, it's like it's cutting your ammo consumption by 2.
Mm-hmm.
But if inconceivable procs on the same shot, all it will do is add 1 ammo to your gun. So basically, if you have that it's one of those all or nothing skills. And by all, I mean 5 out of 5 boosted to 10 out of 5 with a comm.
Mm-hmm.
At that point, you're at 50% chance, and if you have a gun that only uses 1 ammo per shot, theoretically you've got an infinite mag, because half of the shots will remove bullets, and half of them will put bullets back in.
So on a Vladoff gun build, this is an amazing skill you want to almost focus around.
Yeah, it's what makes hoarder builds possible and great. It's as pure ammo mitigation. A double herald, uses 6 bullets per shot. Inconceivable will cut that to 0 half the time. Mm-hmm. And this one will cut it from 6 to 4 half the time. So it's...
That's a big deal, though, when you're taking 6 ammo per shot and pistols don't have the biggest ammo pool.
Yeah, it can be good, though. At that point, you'd better be better off with another prefix on your arrow. So the 3 ammo consumption would be down to 1.
Yeah.
But this thing shines with guns that only use 1 ammo per shot.
Yep.
Because it makes them infinite.
All right. Yippee-ki-yay next, going down to tier 4. Killing an enemy while gunzerking increases the amount of time you can gunzerk. So another duration, 3 seconds per kill, which is a pretty big deal because...
Last Longer's bigger brother. Yeah. Those two combined, Last Longer and Yippee-ki-yay, make the get some loop possible. Mm-hmm. It's. I don't think I've done a build without this skill in... Nope. I don't think I've ever got at this skill.
Yeah, it's... I'll get to that with the last one. But yeah, I mean, the longer you're in gunzerking, which means you can get some, which means your chance of not having cooldown is higher, and you can just permanently gunzerk, and that's a big fucking deal. Because...
Yep.
This is what makes Sal broken, in my opinion. It's these 3 skills. It's not money shot and inconceivable. It's the fact that you can permanently be in your action skill. And while he's in his action skill, he can, you know, have the grog in one hand and something else in the other. You know, if I could permanently be able to phase lock and just have like a permanent subsequence active, that would make Maya pretty broken. Not even quite as broken as Sal, because bosses it wouldn't do much, but... Yeah, the fact that he can pretty much permanently gunzerk, which means he's doing way more damage, he's got way higher survival. You know, imagine 0 if he could permanently many must fall chain without getting kills just by hitting enemies with melee.
I don't think that's what makes him broken, but it's what makes him good. That's for sure. Without these, Sal would be kind of boring, I'd say, because... What's fun with Sal is to always be in Gunzerk. That's where the show is, you know. Mm-hmm. But without these, it would be like 30 seconds of Gunzerk and then 45 seconds of cooldown where you have to hide.
A long time of cooldown, yeah.
Exactly. But I don't think in and of itself Gunzerk is what makes Sal broken. Come to think of it, if the rocket launcher Pimpernel glitch didn't exist, and you couldn't chain money shots, and the high roll didn't exist, I think people would be saying that Sal is too weak.
Probably. Maybe. Now, there's so many things. That's the thing with like the Sal being broken conversation. I know it's a weird place to get into it, but like, it's no matter how you look at it, it's this big combination of things. It's not like one thing. It's like 20 things tied together.
But almost all of Sal's good builds that everyone uses, like, oh, this makes Sal broken, are all based on one particular glitch. Mm-hmm. Sal is just a huge collection of glitches. But from a design standpoint, if those glitches didn't exist, Sal wouldn't be too strong. He would be just on par with everyone else.
Yeah. And then there's obviously just the grog. And that's a problem. But we'll get to that when we talk about the
grog. All right.
So double your fun. I love this. Throwing a grenade while you gunzerk causes you to throw 2 grenades. The second one does not cost ammo. This is just such a cool thing.
Yeah. It's there's really no explanation necessary. It's just you throw 2 of these. And basically it... doubles your ammo count for grenades.
Yep.
And it doubles the speed at which you can chuck them. Yep. So, for 1 point.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
I wouldn't skip that.
No. then get some. So, shooting an enemy decreases your gun zerking cooldown. This effect can occur once every 3 seconds. And you get -3 seconds per shot. And those 3 seconds are going for 3 seconds, right? So yep. you get 1 second per second, basically, and that's why it works basically. With keep it
piping. As long as you're, hitting things, you get almost natural cooldown while you're gunzerking.
Yep.
To me, this is Sal's best skill. Yeah. People are going to say that Munshot is very good, and it allows a lot of glitches to ride him to brokenness. But get some is what makes Sal Sal. Mm-hmm. It's one of those skills. I've never done a build without. I've done it once and it sucked, and I suspect and I respect 10 minutes afterwards. It's just so good. There's no reason to skip this ever.
And Ryoko said the same thing, and Ryoko is one of those other Borderlands minds that I absolutely respect beyond most, and he agreed with you 100% here.
No, it's because it's a subtle effect. It's not like those, like Money Shot gets a big, like a big sound when it goes off, and get those big numbers with a K at the end of it. But it's much more subtle. But it, in and of itself, it makes Sal a pleasurable experience for me.
What also makes this really good is it's just shooting enemies. It's not killing them. So. Badassosaurus Rex, Saturn, and the Peak. You have to
tag things.
Yeah, so many of those enemies that you can't get kills off of. Well, I guess Saturn's got its turrets, but there's a lot of enemies where you can't get kills off of to proc those kind of skill, or those kill based things. This works just by shooting things.
Yep. It's amazing. It's almost like. I mean, even if you're doing a pure rocket launcher build, it's worth it to swap to another gun once in a while just to activate it.
Yeah, just whip out a Vladoff pistol and shoot a bunch of things. And I guess fire rate doesn't even matter because it's once every 3 seconds. It's not that hard to shoot something once every 3 seconds. So
just shoot a quad once in the general direction of something that needs to be killed, and you're almost assured to have it.
Proc. So last, keep firing. Well, gunzerking, the longer you hold down the trigger, the faster your guns fire, and the faster you reload. Fire rate up to 88%, reload speed up to 25. So basically on everything except for Jacob's builds and maybe Dahl, which you're not really doing Dahl stuff with Sal anyways, it's freaking amazing.
The thing with that skill is that the condition for that is holding down the triggers, and that's usually what you're doing anyway.
Yep.
So it's just a free bonus. It's really, really, really good. There's no reason to skip this unless you're going Jacobs, of course.
Do you know how long it takes to get your fire rate to 88% or to get to the max bonuses?
I know that after 5 or 6 seconds, it's completely in. As a bonus, but I don't know if it's maybe 3 or 4 seconds, but it's usually within, yeah, it's pretty quick.
Is this also one of those things that doesn't disappear when you let go of the trigger, that kind of slowly goes down and you push the trigger and it goes back up? Kind of like your reverse recoil and stuff?
I don't know. Okay. I don't know that. When we're finished with this, I will actually go and test it. I think it completely resets.
Okay.
But I've never tested it. One interesting thing, though, is that if you're using a Jacobs shotgun that only has one shot in the mag, you can actually hold the trigger and get the reload speed bonus. Well, not the fire rate bonus, obviously, because it's just one shot. But you do get the reload speed bonus that way.
Okay. So, yeah, that's the Rampage Tree. So this would be your normal mode tree you would start with, right?
Yeah, after putting 5 points in hard to kill, just to get a bit some more survival. Health, I would go down that one. Yeah,
I would go down imagine you probably won't get some as soon as possible.
Yeah. I would imagine. It's a bit like the middle tree for Zero. This is the foundation for Sal.
Mm-hmm.
Almost all builds benefit from this one. Be it saving on ammo or making your Gunzerk longer. I mean, there's no reason to go Brawn and Gunlust. It wouldn't work as well.
Like with Maya, I always want to get Converge really fast because Converge is kind of what makes her work. And this tree to me is kind of like that same thing as her motion tree. And you got to go deeper to get some, but you know, you're get some yippee-ki-yay and last longer. That's really makes Sal work.
If I only had to spec in three skills for Sal, it would be those three.
All right.
Yeah.
Let me get a comm that doesn't have anything in the next tree. All right. So the Brawn tree, then. This is what people kind of consider his weakest tree. And I think there's some truth to that, but it doesn't mean it's a terrible wasted tree.
Yeah, it's just that so many skills in that don't scale well, so it's kind of hard to either rely on it or go down that tree without picking some pretty weak things.
Yeah, and I always argue with Maya, like, the Grog doesn't evaluate her healing tree, but to Sal, it kind of does to a point, doesn't it?
It does, because even if you're... If you max out the Brawn tree and all the health three and skills, and then use a comm to boost these in further, and you might match what a Moxie gun will do as healing efficiency, but you're not gonna.
Yeah, I've seen people do builds to make it work, but they can work, but they're never that great. And it takes like a high skill level player to even kind of pull it off a lot of times.
It does work, but like you said, it takes it. You can't just be standing still and shooting things.
Mm-hmm.
Because with if you're relying on Moxie guns, then your healing comes from shooting things. So if you're standing still and getting in the face of the what you're shooting, then you'll get more healing. But Brawn healing is reliant on time, not the damage that you dish out.
Yep.
So you don't have anything to gain by getting in your enemy's face. You're much better off taking cover, ducking, and using movement speed to avoid those bullets.
Yep.
It can work, but it makes Sal more involved. Like what I said at the beginning, that Sal was more, you build one and let it loose. Mm-hmm. If you're doing a bronze Sal, it's no longer true.
Right. So getting to the skills there, hard to kill. Increases your maximum health and gives you a small amount of health regen. Max health plus 20%. And then regenerates 0.5% of your health per second.
Health regen is negligible. It's the max health that's interesting with this one.
But the fact that it stacks a little bit on top of your Gunzerking thing does help a little bit. And I always go on this rant in these videos. Passive healing helps fight dots, and dots are some of the most dangerous things at endgame.
Yeah. At 0.5%, it's either you throw it on the pile, because you'll get, like, Inca Time Bleeds, Sexy T-Rex, and stuff like that. So it's not wasted, but you can already fight dots really well without it.
Sell. Yeah.
And if you only have that, it won't be enough to fight dots.
No, not only this. It's just one of those things like, well, you're getting it for the extra health, and it's going to just help you a little bit.
Yeah, so it's not. Yeah, it's a solid skill, all in all. If you have a Gunlust and Rampage build mostly, you'll have points left, and this is a great place to spend them.
Next, Insight, which taking damage from enemies increases your movement speed and reload speed for a few seconds. I love this personally. I'm assuming you do too, because movement speed is great, and you're going to be taking damage from enemies because you're Sal.
Yeah, you will. Exactly. It's one of those really, really solid tier one skills. And the cool thing with that is like about 5 or 6 comms boosted. so pretty much whatever you're doing, you'll get a boost to it, really. It's... I don't know. It's so easy to proc, and movement speed isn't such a big deal usually, but with Sal it is, because you can't ADS, you can't shoot from long range, you can't get behind cover, so movement speed is kind of the thing that makes you avoid bullets and rockets. Mm-hmm. It's and gets you better placed in the environment and stuff like that. So it's movement speed is a much bigger deal with Sal than with any other character.
Yeah, I mean,
in my opinion,
Gage and Axton have pets for aggro relief. Maya's got phase lock for crowd control. Zero's got deception.
Yeah,
I guess maybe Krieg and Sal it would be almost equal to
Krieg would get a lot for movement speed increase, yeah. Especially with Bozak's Rampage. If you have, you don't have to get within range of your enemy, you have to get literally in their face.
Yeah.
Well, so, yeah. he doesn't have any.
Two.
Yeah, the same logic applies to Sal.
Yep. Asbestos reduces the duration of enemy elemental status effects on you, minus 40% duration. I don't know about this. A lot of people, I hear people arguing about it. It's a waste. You don't need it, or it's good because, again, I think dots are scary. What's your take on it? Since I don't really have one.
I don't really have one either. It's one of those. I don't know. When I try to go down the Brawn Tree, I will take hard to kill. That's for mm-hmm. sure. Because I'm trying to health stack to get those person bages regenerate bonuses, and I will usually take insight too. Because I really like it.
Yep.
So I don't. I kind of don't have to wait. The benefit of taking asbestos, because I usually skip it, but it's...
You also have, I mean, a lot of times with Sal, let's be honest, you're holding a grog in one hand, so you have some
chance to
fight dots
yeah.
anyways.
And fight dots are not so... If you're going down the Brawn Tree, dots mm-hmm. are not that scary, because
yeah.
you get, what, 4% from in-gun time to bleed, 2% to 4% from 60 TRX, depending on the...
And you have passive health regen just while gunzerking.
Exactly. And considering that usually health stack with Sal, like using a Evo or Neo as a shield, mm-hmm. probably using...
Or Rough Rider.
Or Rough Rider and hard to kill, then those little percentage of health regen...
Get a lot
they represent... Yeah, they're bigger, and usually you can fight dots just by standing still.
All right, fair enough. So with all that, you might not need this, or
It's not a bad skill. It's one I need to test further to have a definitive opinion on it.
All right, fair enough. I think on other characters this would be amazing, but maybe Sal's got so many other ways to avoid dots that it's not that big of a deal. Like Zero,
yeah.
again, would love this.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
He's the one that's probably most scared of him. I'm the Juggernaut next, then, is a kill skill. Killing an enemy reduces all damage taken for a few seconds.
This is a heartbreaker.
Yeah.
This skill could have been so good. It could have enabled Brawn to be a legit tree on its own. But the bonus is way too small.
Mm-hmm.
At 5 out of 5, 20%, and considering that Gunzerking gives you 50% as a base bonus, it's barely noticeable. Even at 10 out of 5, it's like... At 10 out of 5, it's noticeable, but it's not doing much.
Mm-hmm.
If the bonus was much higher, let's say 10% per point instead of 4, or maybe 15% per point, then it would make the whole Brawn Tree so much better, because everything in it that heals is regenerative healing. So this would give you the time to heal from those skills and make Brawn, you know, it would make Brawn work. But as it stands, it just doesn't. Either you're taking too much fire and you're going down, or you're not taking any fire at all, in which case Brawn is...
Isn't damage reduction is not as good as damage resistance. They're different formulas.
Yeah, it's the one that if you have... This one is the one that if you have 100%, it just reduces your damage in half. It doesn't make you immune to damage. Mm-hmm. So that 20% is actually 13 point something actual damage mitigation. Yeah. But it's even lower if you consider that while you're Gunzerking, you have already 50% damage reduction. It's one of those skills. This skill actually makes me angry. It's
I like it.
It could have been so great. It could have, and the Titan come as a boost to it. It could have rounded up the Brawn Tree. You have all those skills that give you health regen, and there's this one that would make you take less damage, so that healing would have time to do its work. Okay. But it just doesn't.
If it was 20% resistance, would it be good enough?
Oh yeah, it would. Or if it was like 20% per point.
Yeah.
Or something like that.
Because if it was 20% resistance and you stack that with a Rough Rider, now you're sitting like 40% resistance, and then the 50% reduction from Gunzerking, that's a different story.
Yeah.
Or 60% resistance out of 10 out of 10 with a Rough Rider.
That would have been great, because if you get down that tree to come at me, bro, mm-hmm. you get that damage reduction, and it's 250% for I don't know how many seconds. This one works if I'm the Juggernaut at, well, maybe not 250%, but if it was within the vicinity of that kind of efficiency, it would have made the Brawn Tree work at OP 8. It just fixed that one skill and the Brawn Tree would work.
All right.
And just drop a point in it if you're comboosted, or otherwise just skip it.
Fair enough. Next is Ain't Got Time to Bleed. While Gunzerking, you regenerate health. The lower your current health, the more powerful it is, 4% per second. Is the max cool. of it. Yeah. This is a lot like Sustenance, but more powerful, but only active during your Gunzerking. But let's be honest, you should always be Gunzerking.
Yeah, exactly.
And when you stack this with Hard to Kill and the passive from Gunzerking, that's quite a bit.
Yeah.
Do you know what the passive on Gunzerking is?
It's about 2%.
All right. But if you're looking at... if you're looking around 6.5% with these three combined... That's a big number. Like that, you're right. That will fight DOS to the point where you really don't need Asbestos, especially exactly. if you health stack.
The only thing with that skill that's not to my liking is that no-com boosts it. If there was one of the Brawn, like either the Beast Tank or Titan or one of those that's focused on Brawn, if one of these boosted Ain't Got Time to Bleed, maybe Brawn would be viable at OP8 even without fixing on the Juggernaut. Yeah.
Because if you boosted Hard to Kill and this with one com, I mean that's 9% right there, plus your Gunzerking. Getting that passive up to that point and you health stack, and let's say you throw an evolution on top of it, which I think is again like 2-2.5%, you're looking at almost 15% per second.
That's legit. That would have been enough. Yeah. That would have been enough to make Brawn on its own viable at OP8.
Yep.
But it's the sad thing with Brawn is that there's only one piece of the puzzle missing.
Yep.
Either fix Sam the Juggernaut or boost Ain't Got Time to Bleed with one of the comms or... It doesn't have to, it wouldn't need much to be good.
It's so close, yeah. Next, Fistful of Hurt, melee override. Press R to throw all of your weight into a punch, causing massive damage and knockback. The enemy Fistful of Hurt has a cooldown. Well, Fistful of Hurt is on cooldown. You will perform a regular melee attack. I really like this. It's not necessary or anything. But that knockback is really nice for the enemies in your face, and you just push them back and then shoot them in the face while they're stunned.
Yeah, especially for those builds like with the slow hands, where if you shoot something that's in your face, you'll damage yourself.
Yep.
And little detail with this one, it knocks back more than one enemy at a time.
Nice.
If you nail in front of you, if there's three or four guys in front of you, it will knock back all of them at the same time.
I would assume it's pretty nice on, like, rabbit enemies that are quite annoying.
Yeah, it works great on them, yeah. It's also the basis for most melee builds with Sal, because the damage bonus is pretty big. I don't know the number exactly, but it's sizable.
Okay. But it's probably not worth, like, if you're down here and you got the point, grab it, but it's not really worth going to... If you're not down this far,
it's worth going down that far to get it. If you're,
of course, hard
doing,
to kill, an insight will get you there.
Yeah, if you're going for like a slow hand build or any build that relies on a weapon that will kill you if you're shooting something that's in your face, mm-hmm. it's worth it.
Okay,
like a sword explosion too, and guns like that.
Next is Out of Bubblegum. Increases your fire rate with all gun types while your shields are depleted. Now, I know this has got some weird restrictions, doesn't it?
Yes and no. Your shield has to be depleted. So if you're using... one of the comms that boosts it is the Titan... Legendary mm-hmm. Titan. It's, and the Titan has a shield capacity penalty on it. So it would take the Rough Rider, that would be a prime shield to use with that, mm-hmm. and takes it below zero, so it kind of breaks it and it doesn't work.
Okay, that's the one.
Yeah. Otherwise, if you're using a regular shield on it, there's no real problem with that.
Okay. Just the Rough Rider with the one comm.
Usually that would be the best combination if you're using a Legendary Titan, is like to get 10 out of 5 out of Bubblegum, so you don't have to go down to keep firing and lay waste. You can concentrate on Brawn and get all your DPS from there. But since you can't use the Rough Rider, you have to kind of compromise and use another shield, so... If you're using Brawn, your health stacking, so it's probably going to be the Evo or the Neo, and those have a fairly quick delay.
Yeah.
So it's I don't know. In and of itself, it's a good skill, but the rest of Sal's kit around it make it a bit hard to use properly.
So it's more of a gear problem than a skill problem almost.
Yeah, the skill in and of itself is great. I mean,
yeah.
Fire rate when shield is depleted, it's
good.
I mean, it's great.
But, and you want more fire rate when your shield's down because you're closer to dying and you want to be able to put out more hurt and survive. And
yeah.
But you want to be able to abuse it, have it always on. Mm-hmm. So if that comm didn't have that shield penalty with a Rough Rider, it'd be perfect.
Yeah. It's
and then boosting
one of those,
it 70% always on fire rate would be insane.
Yeah, it's one of those. Here's one of the Brawn missing puzzle pieces.
Yep.
If the Titan didn't have that shield penalty, then you would be able to use it with the Rough Rider. You would get that damage resistance or reduction similar to what the Juggernaut gives you. And it would, once again, it would make Brawn just a tiny bit better to push it into usable territory. But it's...
Everything is so close.
Yeah, exactly.
Then next we have Bust That Can't Slow Down. Increases your movement speed while gunzerking by 50%. I mean, that's a pretty big deal.
It is. If you're that far down the tree, there's no reason not to pick this.
Yep.
It's, as I said earlier, movement speed with Sal is just, it's much more important.
And when you add this to Insight, and you're going fast as fuck.
Yeah, yeah, and it's kind of necessary with some guns, because Sal usually will use powerful guns that aren't that accurate, and so you tend to have to to play in your face at short range and close the enemy as fast as you can. And this helps a ton. Plus, against raid bosses too. I mean, at 5 out of 5 in that, and 5 out of 5 in sight, you can't outrun Verocitus, but pretty much everything else.
Our next one in this is weird, tier 4. I think it's one of the only tier 4s in the game with 2 5-point skills. Just got real. Increases gun damage for all gun types. The lower your health, the greater the damage bonus, up to 40%. I really don't like these. The lower your health, the better the gun damage skills, because you don't want to be running around with low health to get the full bonus, and it makes the bonus on him not that great.
If it was, like, inconceivable, like, if your shield is depleted, it counts as, you know, getting the full bonus and stuff, but it's health, and it's linear.
Yep.
To get the full bonus, you have to be in 5 for your life.
Yeah.
I really don't like it. Get your gun damage bonus somewhere else and keep your health high.
Yep.
It's not worth it.
If the damage, if it was a better bonus, maybe. Because then even when your health is kind of high, you know, you're still getting a decent number, but
yeah. It would have to be like on par with what Painless Power is capable of doing.
Mm-hmm.
What 150% when boosted at its maximum to be really worth it.
Yeah, especially being a tier 4.
Yeah,
when you get down to tier 4 and 5, they should be pretty powerful.
Yeah. I don't like that one.
Sexual Tyrannosaurus. Taking damage causes you to regenerate health for 5 seconds. This effect does not stack. 2% to your max health per second.
They could have just written 2% health regen all the time.
Yeah.
If you're not taking damage, you don't need health regen. So it's needlessly complicated. But it's a good skill.
Well, the weird thing about this to me is sustenance is the same thing, but sustenance is tier 4 and you don't have to take damage. It's just always on. So they move this down a tier,
but and they give you... To sustenance, this one's a flat 2%. It doesn't depend on your health.
Yeah, that's fair enough, but maybe that's why.
It's not. I mean, it should have been tier 4.
Or like, just up the number a little bit, 3%.
Yeah, something like that.
4%. The thing with sustenance, if your health is higher, it doesn't matter that it gets a little bit lower, because you want that higher number when it gets lower.
Yeah.
And, yeah.
The thing with Sal is, like, usually you take damage, like, constantly. All the time, you want that health regain. It's the only one that gives a sizable regen that gets boosted by comms.
Yeah.
So there's that.
So, yeah, but, you can, again, with this, Gunzerking, ain't got time to bleed, hard to kill, let's say an Evo or a Neo, like, that's... You're getting really far up there.
Yeah. It's very close to being usable.
But it's tier 5, it just, I don't know.
Yeah. It should have been about 4%.
Yeah.
So when boosted by a comm, it would get to about 8. And then, you know, it...
Again, I always defend sustenance at tier 4, so I shouldn't be let down by this. But, I don't know, I guess there's a difference between tier 4 and tier 5, and...
The
taking damage doesn't matter too much.
Also, the fact that Maya relies on other kinds of skill, like the orbs and life tab and stuff like that. Well, Sal only has flat health regen.
Yeah.
So it's like, if that's the only thing he has, if that's the only thing he has, he needs to have more of them.
Yep.
As it stands, there's two skills that give sizable health regen and one that gives 0.5%.
Yeah.
So it's, I don't know. It's again, it's missing just one thing.
Or if all those skills are boosted by one comm.
Yeah. Something like that. Even if T-Rex was boosted to, like, let's say twice what it is, and then it was on the same comma as hard to kill. That would be enough. Because then you'd get a bigger max health, a little bit more of health regen from it, and then T-Rex would be like 8%. That you would be able to roughly get 20% per second. That would work.
Mm-hmm.
So close yet again.
So last is come at me, bro. Action skill augmentation. While gunzerking, press your action skill button to taunt your enemies and instantly gain full health. Taunted enemies are more likely to attack you. For the next few seconds, you gain massive damage reduction.
It's 250%, if I remember.
Which is a big deal.
It's pretty good. It basically makes you not invulnerable, but because if you're getting shot at like 10 or 15 bandages at a time, it's not going to save you. But in normal situation, it kind of makes you invulnerable for about 8 seconds. If you're relying on Brawn, there will be time when your health is low enough that you're about to die, and you can't rely on shooting something with a grog to get back up. So you need time, and this gives you time.
Mm-hmm.
It's a pretty good touch on that skill, yeah.
Health back, right?
Yeah, it's full health.
Yeah, you instantly go to full health. So yeah, it's a good emergency button, too. I think the problem with this one, like you were saying, the tree isn't really that great enough to do a Brawn tree.
Yeah.
And you're probably going to just have a Grog or a Ruby, so you don't really need that Brawn tree as much, so you won't be going this deep in it.
Yeah, the capstone itself is good. It's three around it that's not supporting it.
Yeah.
That's the problem. Because on its own, Come At Me Bro is great, but Brawn's just—it's missing just one tiny little thing to make it great.
Yeah, it is. Part of me thinks that Come At Me Bro should be a game changer and not a capstone, but maybe I'm wrong there.
No, I would agree with you.
Yeah, it just seems like this tree. I mean, like you said many times, the tree is so close; it's just not quite there.
A good capstone for that skill would have been something like Life Tap for Sal.
Mm-hmm. Oh, God, yeah. At
something like a 2% or something at one skill point. And have Come At Me Bro be a game changer. And Fistful of Hurt
would, that would have been amazing.
Something like that. It would have made the Brawn Tree very interesting.
Yep. Yeah. Sal had access to Life Tap or Life Steal. Even at low numbers, like, yeah, it's a 1 out of 1, so it's just a flat 2-2.5%, like most regular Moxie guns.
You wouldn't need to rely on Moxie guns that much.
Yeah. And it wouldn't, maybe not always on. Maybe you can activate every, you know, maybe it's, again.
Maybe just when Gunzerking's active or something like that.
Or even kind of like Come At Me, Bro, you can activate it, you know, on a cooldown once every 10 seconds or something, and it last for 5. Like, that would probably be enough with his other healing.
Yeah. Something like that.
Yeah, all in all, the tree is a bit on the weak side.
It's got everything right, but
just a little short.
It's a bit frustrating to think about. It's just missing one tiny detail, just like fix this skill. Fix the number on that one, move that skill to that place, and it would have been great.
Because, like, Sal builds, like, Spunky's Kitty Zerker, which is kind of a joke build, but it somewhat works. Like, those are fun, be able to just run around with stuff like that. It would have been cool to be able to do, like, a Brawn build and be able to go, like, Dueling Butchers. Or, you know, so many of these things that I think would have opened up Sal a lot from the Grog plus X gun, which he kind of gets tied to a little bit, which is
and that's
a little bit limiting.
That's a problem with Sal, and that's why I badly wanted the Brawn Tree to be fixed, is that if you can get your healing from another source than a moxie gun, then it opens up a world of possibilities. Mm-hmm. It's just, oh well.
So, enough on the Brawn Tree?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's move on to the guns then. I'll just start going alphabetical order here. So, assault rifles, I grabbed a few guns here, and if you want to talk about some others I didn't grab. A few of them I grabbed was the Lead Storm. I think this is one of those guns that's really cool on sale. Like, I've seen people be able to raid quite well with this and really crank out the damage with it. Not so much the money shot thing, obviously, it's a deep mag, but with the bullet split, the big mag, he can shoot this thing forever. Five shots or six and inconceivable. And then you can really crank that up, basically.
Yeah. It's probably better on a Brawn build, so you can have two at a time. Mm-hmm. Because using this with any other gun, because the Lead Storm, you kind of have to angle your shots a bit upward, but that throws off your second gun.
Yeah.
So
now I've seen people do it with like the Lady Fist on Terra, because you can crank those crits up with this thing really big and all that and stuff. So if you can aim it right, I mean, that's kind of niche, but.
Well, it's either use two of them or don't use the second gun at all. Just use mm-hmm. it for utility, like the Lady Fist or the Grog to healing and stuff like that. So you don't really rely on it, and you slag with something else, like a grenade.
Going duel with these on Dexy might be fun. Or painful.
It works great. I've tried it on a few maps for a while. Just mm-hmm. to get a sense of it. And it works much better on loaders than it does on bandits because they don't move around so fast.
And they have those multiple crits, which helps your chance of doing that.
Yeah, exactly. If you can get the hang of it, it's absolutely devastating.
It's just going to be a wall of bullets. I also grabbed the Sawbar kind of for similar reasons. I've seen some crazy sell kills with this, and again, he can shoot it forever and crank up the fire rate on this is kind of weak at 5, and he can crank that up, shoot it forever, and just pull out just a wall of death.
Yeah. This is where most of Sal's movement speed bonus comes into factor, because mm-hmm. you have to be at a specific distance for it to work fine. So, yeah, one of those guns that works great with a Brawn build. Would work really great with a Brawn build if Brawn build were good, but otherwise it's very, very efficient.
Mm-hmm. I also grabbed the Becca just because the Becca is so damn good. Now this is a little hard to use with Sal because he doesn't always love Jacobs outside of shotguns, but with 16 in the mag, he can actually get money shot on this really fast, especially with its fire rate. If you can handle pulling the trigger while gunzerking, and its damage and the penetration and everything. Like, I've done Terra kills and peak runs with Becca builds with Sal, and they actually work surprisingly well, but it's not that popular of a thing because it's not hold down the trigger.
It's kind of awkward to have to spam a trigger mm-hmm. when you have two of them. So it's,
well, I would usually do, I did that one joking, but usually it'd be a Grog or a Lady Fist in the offhand, and Becca's got the type B crit, which makes the Lady Fist so much bigger. Yeah, so this with either the Grog or a Lady Fist in the offhand goes pretty nuts.
Yeah, it's one of those guns that's good on everyone, so why not on Sal?
Yeah. And then the other one I grabbed was the Kitten, because obviously Spunky's Kitty Zerker, but this is one of those ones that kind of, I think, opens it up a little bit. He likes bullet hosing, and this bullet hoses with the best of them. It's really ammo efficient with the x3 for one bullet, and Sal can pretty much unlimitedly shoot it with 5 shots or 6 and inconceivable.
Yeah.
And it gives you your healing. The hail's kind of in this range, too. I didn't bring that with me, but hail's a little bit harder to aim with Sal running around and doing that.
Yeah. The Kitten's actually my favorite AR with Sal. It either dual Kitten or mm-hmm. when using another AR, I can use the Kitten in the offhand, mm-hmm. like slag kitten in the offhand to get that the ranged likeness damage bonus.
Yep.
It's and that to that moxie healing. It's
and it really doesn't have recoil either.
No, just it kind of stays there. So
yeah, it's kind of got a wide spread, but he has accuracy bonuses to help that a little bit.
Like widespread with Cell is kind of a given.
Yeah.
Really. Because if you can't ADS, then you're going to get to max accuracy at some point if you keep shooting.
Mm-hmm.
So you kind of have to assume that this what that's what's going to happen and pick your guns based on that.
Yeah. So if you guys haven't seen the Kitty Zerker, Spunky's got a few videos of that. Maybe I'll link them. I usually don't link other people's content, but the Kitty Zerker is pretty hilarious and awesome. Any other AR? Like, Sal doesn't particularly love ARs, I don't think.
Let's see, the Ogre. The Ogre is pretty good.
I almost brought the Ogre with me, yeah.
Because it only uses one ammo per shot, so it's great with five shots or six. And it's neutral element, so you can use it pretty much everywhere. And the big mag and spinny gun and stuff like that, it works great with keep firing. And
keep it piping hot also boosts the splash on it, and it's got high splash, yeah. So that's exactly legit. Pistols then, I mean, I kind of brought the obvious here, the Herald.
Yeah.
We all know the Herald with Sal. I brought the Anarchist because Sal can pretty much turn this into an Infinity.
Yeah, pretty much.
And same thing kind of goes for the Stalker and Stinger. Stalker, Stinger, Anarchist, they're all pretty close in terms of DPS.
Yeah, pretty much.
I don't know if you have an opinion on which one you like best with Sal.
If I remember right, the Stinger is like an Anarchist with reflecting bullets, so it's
slower
kind of
bullet speed, too.
That
or
would
is
be
that
the Stalker,
right? Yeah.
It's the Stalker, I think.
Yeah, higher damage, slower.
Yeah. The higher damage of the Stalker, I don't think makes up for the slow bullets. Because since you can't ADS or lead your target, really, it's kind of awkward. I'd rather go with an Anarchist or a Stinger.
Okay, that's fair enough. Obviously, we know the Lady Fist because it's 800% critical hit damage, makes it awesome in the offhand or as a main gun. Reverse recoil, Sal loves, because then he can crit.
Yeah. I mean, whenever you add a 800% crit bonus to anything else, it's, I mean...
ridiculous.
Yeah. Lady Fist plus anything else equals...
yeah. Instant death. Yeah, this is one of those things. We know this is boosted during the loot hunt. It used to be 400. There's some other guns at, like, what, 500-600 crit, but now that this at 800. And that's one of those things that's part of the, like, the formula that makes Sal broken, the fact that critical hit transfers offhand or to main hand, both ways.
Yeah,
actually.
Can I stop you there for a second?
Sure.
I really don't like the term transfer for that.
Okay.
I know it's nitpicking, but it kind of it confuses people. Like, is this gun transferring his bonus to that gun, or does this work in the opposite? There's no transfer. It's just you add all the bonuses that all of your gear and skills give. Just Sal just happens to be able to wield two guns at a time, so he just gets the bonus. I mean, you don't feel like, oh, killer comm from Zero transfers its crit bonus to the gun
that's
he's holding.
Enough. It's just, it is a little bit different though, because if I'm a newbie playing Borderlands 2 and I'm holding, you know, a Lady Fist in one hand and a Muck-a-Muck in the other, I wouldn't know that Lady Fist critical hit applies to the Muck-a-Muck.
Yeah, you would, but it's, I think. The reason why I prefer not to use the term transfer is it's much easier to explain to new players that you just add all of your crit bonuses together and they apply to all of your guns.
Yeah.
So it's
fair enough.
Yeah, I didn't want to sound like too nitpicky on that, but I feel that it's a distinction that needs to be made.
Did you say transfer? They think it maybe stays on it, or
yeah, it's like it kind of sends a message like, oh, this one transfers its bonus, so do it still keeps its bonus, or does the transfer kind of copies it, or is no, you get all of the crit damage bonuses that you have applies to every gun that you have.
All right.
No matter the source.
Everyone listening, you heard this, we're fighting this fight from now on.
I just feel it's easier to use that to explain it to new players than to speak about transferring bonuses. It's just...
That makes sense.
To me, it's confusing, so...
I get it. But yeah, basically the Lady Fist giving any other gun you hold 800% critical hit bonus... That's insane. Because I mean, there's no skill outside of Critical Ascension, which would cause you to do a lot of stacking to get to 800.
There's nothing that get close to that.
And there's no critical hit relic. The biggest critical hit bonus on a class mod, I think, is around, 50% maybe?
Yeah, 50. I mean, 55 or something like that.
Something to that range. I mean, this is just ridiculously huge. So the ability to do that is insane. And... Yeah,
on its own, the Lady Fist is properly balanced, because if you're holding the Lady Fist, then obviously you're shooting with the Lady Fist, because that's the only gun you have. But Sal kind of breaks that, and that's what makes Sal interesting for me, is that since he has two guns, you can go and make those combos. Yep. I mean, obviously, this one's very obvious, but even if it was like pre-loot hunt bonus at 400%,
still really good.
Yeah, adding 400% crit bonus to a Jacob's Coach gun or a Hyperion Thinking or the Conflict Skull, for example, that's a big deal.
Oh,
that's
hell yeah.
A really big deal. At 800%, it's more than a big deal. It's kind of broken. I've seen people using the Lady Fist in one hand and the Grog in the other, because the Grog's got a Type B crit bonus to get it to, like, I think it's 2,000%, 2,400% crit bonus. Basically, you just shoot Terran in the eye like 3 or 4 times and down it goes.
So, speaking of that, the next one is the Grog, and I wanted to go on a rant about how mad this gun makes me. So, obviously, this is a no-brainer for Sal. It's Slag. Yeah. It's got a high Slag chance.
It does everything.
It has 65% lifesteal, and
it's just,
you guys should just get through everything. Then it has a 250% Type B critical hit bonus.
200.
Is it 200? Okay, yeah, 200.
Yeah, 200.
And the biggest Type B crit bonus in the game outside of this gun is 25%.
Yep. It's
or wait, one gun might have like 30.
I'll let you go on your rant, but right. I'll just this gun shouldn't exist.
Yes.
Period.
So I'll start with the lifesteal. Most Moxie guns are, I think they're somewhat balanced around DPS versus healing. So most of them were around 2-3% lifesteal. And that works just fine. You can easily heal yourself really fast, really full with those kind of Moxie guns putting out that damage. The Ruby kind of had slower fire rate, not the same DPS as those other ones. So it was 12%. And that, I thought, was a good balance. So like with the Ruby, you know, you could throw a grenade and heal or phase lock and heal. And that worked really well. Because you weren't killing... You can kill with the Ruby. It's good enough. But it's not like a killing machine. But then to jump from 12% to 65. Now, I get it. The Grog's got terrible damage, so it's really only used for healing. It was that mission gun. But, like, 20% maybe? But there's no reason to jump all the way to 65. Like, that was ridiculous. Especially because at the time it came out, Moxie guns were already being abused with grenades and stuff like that. So they knew what 65% lifesteal should have been able to do. And then, why does it have a 200% Type B critical hit bonus? the only character that can use its crit bonus is Sal. No one else is going to crit with a Grog and kill things. The Grog's got shit damage. It's slag. But then Sal can just throw it in his offhand. And 200% type B bonus, if you guys watch my Critical Hit Bill Nye or Dirch Nye Critical Hit Guy video, a Grog and a Lady Fist will do more damage than two Lady Fists. Well, not if you hit with both of them, but it will make the critical hit bonus on the Lady Fist bigger than it would with two Lady Fists, and the chance to slag with it is so high. And then the drunk effect you can also abuse. It's just broken on so many levels that it really angers me, because Sal with a Ruby on OP8 is just fine. But the Grog, like, Sal can survive easily with a Ruby and another gun. The 12% is plenty for the damage Sal's putting out. And it's just that critical hit bonus on the Grog is what pisses me off more than anything. Because that's just... it's no other character can abuse it like Sal can, or even abuse it like at all. And yeah,
it's like they thought, what could we give to break Sal completely?
Yeah,
and it this needs to have a high slag chance and give a big multiplicative crit bonus. And it also needs to, let's make it multiply your shots on the other hand.
Mm-hmm.
As well as heal for a ridiculous amount of that. I mean, it's, if I was a 12-year-old modder and I was modding a gun, they're like, this will make me invincible. And that's what I would do.
Yeah.
It's just, I don't know, it's just, it's hilarious. I don't know what we're thinking.
One other dumb thing with it is, at the same time this came out, the Chain Lightning comes out. And now you have a grenade that regenerates that seeks out enemies, so you can just blindly throw it and it'll bounce around and hit a bunch of enemies, and you don't even have to aim your grenades to get instant healing anymore. Like, homing grenades you didn't have to aim, but they're kind of slow. Like, the Chain Lightning, you just throw it out and instantly you're hitting enemies. On top of all that.
Yeah. Oh. I don't know what to add to that. I agree with you 100%.
Yeah. And like I said, I think the Ruby's fine because the healing's still good enough. Ruby has a type... the Ruby still has a type B critical hit. I think it's 25%.
It's much lower. It's like something like 7.5%.
It's something around there.
Yeah.
But the fact that it's just so big, it's just, it's obscene. Anyways, that's pistols. Sorry everyone for that angry rant about the Grog, but I had to do it. Shotguns for Sal.
I play Sal, and I think it's ridiculous and it shouldn't be in the game. So I can't imagine what people who play other characters think of that.
Yeah. If it was at least designed where other characters could kind of get as much out of it, like everyone can heal with it. It's just that crit bonus. That's the thing that makes me angry about it, is like, why would you throw that? Like, you have to intentionally put that in there. And no character can get anything out of that crit bonus except Sal.
And I don't think they realize how big of a mistake it was, because when the pre-sequel came out, there was a mission gun that was exactly like the Grog nozzle. And they had to nerf it.
The probe, yeah.
Probe, yeah. I didn't remember the name.
I don't think the probe had the same type B crit. It just had the healing.
It did.
Did it?
It okay. did. I tried it with Misha, and I could kill things with... I was holding the probe and throwing grenades and relying on Tombstone to kill things.
Oh, okay. And they nerfed it, it was left the Grog.
Yeah. I mean, it was basically a Grog that wasn't locked in elements, yep. And it just put it in the game. It's like, yeah, it worked in the other game, so why not in this one? And... oh, well...
And didn't that get nerfed before the Rosie? That was like the first thing they nerfed, I think.
That was the first thing.
Really fast.
Yeah.
Yeah. So weird. But they left the yeah, anyways. Shotguns. So Sal loves shotguns, I think.
Yep.
They get to money shot faster. He likes to get in your face. They're typically bad with ammo, but he can fix that. So first one I have is the Interfacer, just because this is one of your primary rating guns. It's got the highest DPS of any shotgun.
Thing is, a general gun thing I want to get across is when you're picking guns for your characters, think of their strength and weaknesses and how they match to the strength and weaknesses of your character. Sal has a lot of fire rate bonuses, so guns that are balanced by being slow will be good with him. Mm-hmm. And guns that are powerful but balanced with a small ammo pool will also be good with him, because he's got a lot of ammo mitigation. And that's precisely what shotguns are. They're slow, they're powerful, and they have a small ammo pool. So they're just a perfect match for Sal.
And the Interfacer with that, it's almost got the perfect mag size with him at 14. Which means he, yeah, you know, money shots a minimum of 12. So even if you're not doing the offhand money shot abuse, the Interfacer is just kind of perfectly suited for it.
It's with the unlisted pellets, the inconceivable, the prox money shot, the fast fire rate. If you wanna chain money shots to kill a boss, this is a weapon to do it with.
Yep. And the Interfacer can be somewhat of an ammo issue for other characters. I know I've tried to run it as a main gun on Maya, and I've sometimes had ammo issues, but Sal doesn't have that.
No. You can. I think Baru made a build once. I don't like promoting someone else's channel on yours, but he used dual interfacers, and he never ran out of ammo. Yeah, so
it kind of shows it's true.
It's not an issue with him.
So the next one I brought is a kind of the anti one, because that guy who won't be named anymore hates it and said it sucks. But the Butcher, I love the Butcher. This is not a money shotgun, but you know, the Butcher's special effect is that it pretty much has almost inconceivable built in, or inconceivable plus 5 shots or 6. So the Butcher, when you shoot it, has a chance to not only add ammo to your magazine. And then if you use that on top of Sal's other stuff, like, you can shoot this thing for days.
Yeah.
And crank that fire rate to insane levels.
Pretty much any Hyperion shotgun will be amazing on Sal, because they do everything right.
Yep.
The reverse recoil thing works well with Gunzerking. The Butcher is probably one of the best at that. But every Hyperion shotgun I've tried with Sal was a massive success every time. They're powerful. They shoot fast. I didn't bring
the conference call because I thought that would be overkill listing them. the next one is the Orphan Maker. Now, obviously, this thing is good for many reasons, but I'm just going to let you talk about the Orphan Maker, because you're Chuck.
On average, for a typical Sal user, I wouldn't use this gun at all. But in the context of a deputy build, it's probably the best gun you can have. Because what you want out of your offhand shotgun in a deputy build is two things. You want massive amount of damage, and you want a reasonable accuracy, because that's what you rely on. You're trying to hit crits, you're pacing yourself, and this thing does both. It has I'd say coach gun level accuracy, maybe even slightly better if I remember right, but it has quad level damage. And when it's in your off end, the drawback, which is self damage, disappears. So there's
room to demonstrate that for people.
Yeah, maybe the Twister would be just as good, but otherwise it's I mean, if you're doing a deputy build, this is a gun to get.
Yep. Yeah, the reason why it almost excels above the Twister in that is the Twister's got those really slow bullets that you have to get in their face, but the Orphan Maker's got good enough where you can hit enemies at a decent range, and it's got really fast bullet speed. I mean, some of the best bullet speed in the game. As you can see, this like Hyperion level bullet speed or better. So you can hit enemies at quite a range with it, where the Twister, you don't. Like, Twister probably has more damage than the Orphan Maker, but not the same range.
Yeah, it's not usable, because when you're going deputy, you usually have just one gun that you rely on. So if you're hitting enemies from across the map or trying to hit surveyors, and you kind of have a need for a gun that's accurate and a gun that's powerful. And the Twister is powerful, but it's not accurate.
Yes. Actually, it's insanely accurate. It's just too slow to get anywhere.
Yeah.
It does have like 90% accuracy.
Really?
Yeah. It's really weird. Yeah, the accuracy is high. It's just because the pellets have that big kind of tornado shape to them. You don't think it is, but they actually kind of stay in a very accurate pattern. It's just, it's a really widespread. Yeah, it's kind of weird.
Functionally, it's not.
It's not good at range, but it's accurate. Yeah. so dumb. But the Orphan Maker, like, sometimes also you just need to hit an enemy to heal. And the Orphan Maker can, you know, maybe you're not going to kill him at that range, but you'll land one pellet and that's enough to stay alive.
Yeah.
So this gun with that deputy build and getting money shot every other shot and all that, it kind of turned out to be one of the most powerful builds, and a lot of people have seen running it. You know, I think it excels on things like the dragons, where you can just destroy them so fast.
Gunza seems to play almost exclusively the deputy Sal.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we've all seen what he's done with it. It's crazy. You know, pretty much all the raids. It's not the best on Terra, but it works on Terra.
Yeah.
But a lot of the other ones, it just wrecks the shit out of them. Next one I brought is the Jolly Roger. The Jolly Roger. I mean, I don't think Bandit shotguns, we agree, aren't the best, but the Jolly Roger is a damn good shotgun. And I think, like a lot of the other ones, Sal can just get quite a bit out of this, because it's slow, but Sal can really fix that. Yeah. And it's just a solid stat-wise shotgun.
This also shows that any kind of shotgun in Sal's hand will be great. Because usually Ravagers and other big shotguns that are very slow, like the Jolly Roger, they usually they suffer from that fire rate. But Sal kind of fixes that, and also that big ammo consumption, Sal fixes that too. So it's really hard to find shotguns that don't work great on Sal.
That's when I was going through shotguns, I kind of ran into that issue. I'm like, they're all kind of good. Like, which ones do I pick? We can't talk about them all. Now, for a weapon class that's not so great with him is SMGs. Because he just doesn't synergize with them as well. They don't get the money shot that fast, because they typically have bigger magazines. You're not going to get a lot of overkill damage with them for no kill like overkill. Hip firing, they're not that. They've kind of got bad spreads typically, and not great recoil. So at any kind of range, they're not that great if you can't ADS. Now, if you can ADS, they're fine, but if you can't ADS, they're pretty poor at range. So the ones I brought, first one was the Actualizer and Bitch. Because, reverse recoil, he can make good use out of.
Always good. Always good on Sal.
Yeah.
The thing with SMGs is, like, it's kind of the opposite of what the shotgun were. Shotguns are powerful, and they're slow, and they have a small ammo pool, and those weaknesses are fixed by Sal. And SMGs are fast already, and they have a huge ammo pool, so they... Sal doesn't fix any of their weaknesses, and it kind of falls flat.
Mm-hmm. Now, like, the bitch I do like on him a lot because it's so accurate. It, I mean, it's like the Lady Fist in a way. It doesn't have that big crit, but, you know,
yeah,
it's so easy to crit with it. It's got 75% critical hit damage. It's easy to use on Sal because of reverse recoil, and it's got the best reverse recoil in the game. The other one I brought is the Tattler because this is pretty much like a shotgun in SMG form. And it's really ammo efficient. Three bullets for one shot. That with an 82 natural mag, I think, Sal can just make this into almost an infinity.
It has great DPS, so that's why it works great.
And then last one, because we won't spend too much time on it, Lascal, you recommend bringing this one. So you just want to talk about this?
Alasco?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's great with this one is that a bit like Hyperion guns is it doesn't have any recoil. So shooting from the hip, it doesn't change anything. It's also very easy to get, and it's also very easy to change every two or three levels when you're going through UVHM. It's also pretty hard to get bad parts for this one. If you have a decent grip on it, it'll be fine. And it shoots two bullets at a time, so it's kind of, I mean, Sal's not, it's not SMG, it's not an SMG guy, but this one, when you're leveling up, it does everything right. It's
kind of like the Tattler. It's a bit of a shotgun in SMG form. Like,
exactly, kind of like the Tattler.
But the other thing I'm going to add to this is, even with other characters, I actually prefer to hipfire the Lascal rather than ADS with it. Because its fire rate is so high, I actually feel like I get better DPS. Even with the loss of accuracy, the low recoil and fire rate makes this seem to do better hipfiring than ADS, at least in my experience.
I would have to check again, but I don't think you gain anything by ADSing with this one when it comes to accuracy.
You do get better accuracy. I just actually shot the wall both ways so people can see the difference. You can see it when you rewatch it. But it is tighter, but it's still not extremely tight. Yeah. So there is a difference, but it's not enough of a difference to make up for the fact that, in my mind, just holding that trigger, you can get better fire rate and therefore DPS than the burst.
Yeah.
Which is great for Sal because, you know, he can't ADS with it, and it's a really great hip fire gun. Because you're not going to really crit with it anyways because of the spread, and that's another reason to hip fire with it, unless you're, you know, point blank, which Sal can get the movement speed and survival to do. So, yeah, this gun, you know, great.
As a leveling gun, it's great.
Yeah, and I've said it with a bunch of other characters. This is one of my favorite leveling guns because it is so easy to get. And, you know, you get it in that pool in the Frostburn Canyon, and what you can do is you can just enter, exit, enter, exit, enter, exit, and every time you do that, one drops in the pool, then you can go pick up six of them at once and, you know, get the one that you want, which makes it, you know, easy to farm. And, again, it's so good that, you know, you're not going to really get a terrible one very often, but the fact that you can just warp in and out, you can put 10 of them in the pool, go pick them up, and you're going to get some awesome ones. Sniper's next, then. So again, Sal isn't really a sniper, but he can do cool things with snipers. So... Yeah,
those are snipers you don't snipe with.
Yeah. So I've got the Trespasser here just because knocking off Pete's helmet or Vora kills... You know, there's a good chance if you're a Sal player, you like raiding because Sal's one of the best raiders. And the Trespasser's only real uses are for raid bosses, typically, mostly with Pete and Veracitus. But also, not only knocking off Pete's helmet, but it lets you bypass his shield. And with offhand stuff, Sal can actually do some cool things with this. So that's the reason I have the Trespasser. He can do more with this than most characters because of offhand. Because
he doesn't have to shoot it, actually.
Yep. Yeah, and it's not that great to shoot itself. So Yeah, you can just apply this effect to any other gun that you're holding, which is pretty awesome. I mean, you can do it just regular mobbing and stuff. You don't really need to, but yeah, it's cool for that reason, just to talk about that quickly.
It's a good utility gun to carry around.
Yeah. Yep. The pimp is really here for sale because of the rocket launcher stuff. I don't know if you can probably explain that better than I can.
It's actually pretty good on its own too, but I'll start with the rocket launcher thing. If you're holding the Pimpernel in your offhand, the child projectiles will take on the characteristics of the main handgun. So if you're using it in the offhand and the main hand you have a rocket launcher, then those child projectiles will become the same element as the rocket launcher and carry the same damage. Now, if your rocket launcher is empty, every single little pellet that comes out of that will get the full money shot bonus. So you can pretty much kill raid bosses in like 5 seconds with that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So there's that.
There's that.
Which is but one of the most own, powerful kind of exploits in the game.
Oh yeah, I don't think there's anything that even comes close. I mean, it's not. I usually carry this like a slag pimp and a high magazine derp in my third and fourth slot. Whatever else I'm doing in the first and second slot, I just carry these. And if something annoys me and I've been dying two or three times, I just bring these out
and win. End it.
Yeah, and win. It's a win button.
The
yeah.
slag is a big. Actually, I should have mentioned that too. With that combo, because the child pellets are the ones that get the rocket launcher effect, and there are six child pellets. There's the one that goes up, and then the five that go out. But the main pellet will be slag. So when you do that, the pimp, especially a slag pimp, I think has like a 60% chance to slag, and you have two chances at the bullet and the splash damage. So you do that, you have a really good chance of slagging that enemy, and then the other ones go and hit to have the slag advantage, which is even more ridiculous.
It works with all elements, but slag is by far the best to get if you want to do that trick.
Yeah, the fact that you can get multi-elements out of... Yeah, it's so ridiculous.
That's one of those things that makes people say that Sal is an easy mode, but it's one of those things that if you remove it, like, Sal gets much more reasonable as a character.
Yep.
On its own, though, the pimp is actually very good on Sal. I think Slijim, one of the builds he made was the pimp slapper, and that's what he used mainly. He used the grog in his offhand and shock pimp. He used shock just because whatever in his main hand. Yeah, it's neutral. Basically, what he says, like, I'm using shock because this is so good anyways that matching element isn't, like,
needed.
I don't even bother.
Yeah.
Just aim for crotch and...
win.
Yeah.
And again, the pimp is kind of slow, and that helps it speed it up. And with the Mollywon parts, it's got just about right mag size for money shot as well.
Yeah.
So,
and another interesting detail is that if you're, let's say you're doing a Brawn build and you want to dual wield these, like one pimp in each hand, the child projectile, just as like with the rocket launcher trick, the child projectile will take on the element of your main hand gun. So if you're using a, let's say you're in a flesh zone, sort of fire gun in your main hand and slag in your offhand, your offhand will slag with the original projectile, but the child will be fired too. So you get the best of both worlds.
And you can just have a fire and a corrosive one and be able to deal with anything by just swapping those two.
Yeah, exactly.
That's cool. Other snipers is the Liuta, because... Yeah.
Or just about every flat of sniper out there. But the Liute is the best one of them. A good fire rate, one ammo per shot. The split is also nice. A high crit bonus. It just you can get this to fire like faster than an SMG with Sal. So
yeah,
it's in a hoarder build. You can actually just hold on the trigger and never run out of ammo, even if it's just even if it's still the small point. Yeah, it's
damn powerful.
It's a great feeling.
The last one I brought was the longbow.
Yeah, it's kind of a neat alternative to using a Pimpernel. If you like want to main hand this and don't feel like aiming for crotches, or if you're not that great with it, this will deal about as much damage as a Pimpernel would. Including the child projectiles. And considering it's Hyperion, usually when you hip fire a Hyperion sniper rifle, reverse recoil the fire rate is too slow for the reverse recoil to do anything good. Mm-hmm. But with Sal, you can get this very, very pinpoint accurate and keep on critting with it.
Yep, and you can fire it for a lot longer because it's kind of got a small, you know, it's a 10 meg here, so he can get it up, keep firing it. And it's got a crit bonus where it's with the crit accessory is 170, without the crit accessory it's 150. Yeah. So very good crit, very high base damage, really easy to fire if you can learn that arc, which isn't too bad. And yeah, you can just stay on point.
Yeah.
And it's fun. I didn't bring any launchers with me. I totally blanked on that, I guess. Is there any launchers you want to talk about?
Launchers. The Topnia. That would be the best one. Because with most of Sal's ammo mitigation skill active, you can shoot rocket launchers forever. There's just bring a sham or not. It actually works well without the sham too. And put on a hoarder comm, and between inconceivable 5 shots or 6 and the Vladov launcher gimmick of not expanding ammo in 1 or 3 shots, I think you can actually clear maps and have and sustain your ammo pool.
Nice.
Yeah. Other than that,
then your pimp offhand stuff, you just want highest damage and element usually, so that's usually Norfleet, right?
Actually, the Derp would be the better choice.
Oh, really? That's got higher.
Because it's the child projectile don't take into account the multiplicative, so Norfleet is kind of times 3.
Times 3. Yep.
So it doesn't take that into account. And the other thing is that the characteristics, not just the damage and element, the characteristics of the launcher gets applied to those child projectiles. And the Derp, which is a Torg rocket launcher with a Torg mm-hmm. barrel, it has really, really slow rocket speed. So those child projectiles will get a very small arc and go very slowly. So they won't get spread across the room. They'll stay inside whatever you want to kill.
Good. Okay. I forgot about that part of it. All right. So that's guns.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think there's... I mean, launchers are just kind of launchers.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't find them that interesting. shields, the Rough Rider is an obvious choice, I think, for Sal because of inconceivable health stacking, damage resistance.
Yeah, it's a prime choice for raiding. As a mobbing shield, I'm not sold on it. I'm not convinced that it's better than an Evo or an EO or something else you might want to try on. Because every time you come out of Fight for Your Life, you're like below health gate and you don't have your shield.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good point. So it's kind of... what can happen is, like, you go down, and then you go back up, and then you go back down immediately.
Yeah, the fight for your life loops are a thing.
Yeah, so I'm not... It's awesome for raids, because it enables Inconceivable and Auto Bubblegum, but for I don't know. I'm personally much prefer the Evo.
Okay. And that's actually the next shield I have here. I'm switching between the Evo and the Neo, which are pretty comparable, and they have the same max health bonus, the same resistance. The Evo's got better capacity.
Yeah.
And the Neo's got better recharge rate and delay. So they're pretty comparable with each other.
Yeah, it's personal preference at that point.
Yep. But yeah, they're both great too because they have passive health regen, which stacks with Sal's all of his other stuff to make that even better.
And the
max health is bigger than the max health bonus on a Rough Rider. So you can get to higher health values with these. And then the elemental resistance really helps survival as well.
Yep, all in all, pretty much a good fit for Sal.
So the blast, I brought the blast-proof tortoise as well. What's the con that does that?
It's either the raider.
Yep.
It's the raider, yeah.
So the tortoise, when it's a turtle shield that lowers your health and all that, but if you have a low-level one with the auspicious raider, which lowers your shield capacity, your shield breaks and stays down like the Rough Rider, and you get this movement speed bonus. It's not something for raiding, really, but if you're mobbing and you want to get some places fast or farming for something, Sal's got enough survival to kind of put this on and go through and destroy things and get where you want. You know,
like Ganza if you uses this a lot
with the deputy build for farming tubbies.
Like, if you want to play without a shield, like when we talk about the Rough Rider, that's why I'm not convinced that Rough Rider is that great for mobbing. Like, if you don't mind not having a shield when mobbing and your build is based on money shot, then this is a better choice, in my opinion.
Yeah. Yeah, because I'm running around here while gunzerking. I went into all those skills and put this on, and people can see how fast you're going. It's pretty ridiculous how fast he can move with this. I mean, his normal speed and sprinting speed. Well, sprinting is faster, but yeah, you can move insanely fast with all this stuff. Other shields, I mean, you got your typical blockade antagonists. They're always good.
Those are always good, but they don't have... They're good.
The Sal synergies.
Yeah. Sal doesn't really have any synergy with shields in general.
Yep.
So the best one for him are those that increase his health.
Yep.
Because he's got synergy with that. Other than that, did you bring a sham?
I forgot of sham. I did bring the bee. Wow. The bee's the bee. I don't think we have to talk about it.
Because the sham is not... No, the bee is not... It's not. The bee's the bee.
There's sometimes when you're raiding, you're still going to wear the bee, but you don't need to rely on the bee at all.
The sham is special synergy with Sal for rocket launcher builds. That's the one place. Because if you're using a main hand Topnia, you can regain your ammo as you're using it and stay top tough. You don't need it, but in eras where enemies wield guns anyways, it's not wasted, and it's a great fit for hoarder build that uses rocket launchers.
So the last one I brought with me here is the Flame of the Firehawk. Just because with Sal, a lot of times you're playing up close and personal, Sal doesn't have any really recharge rate or delay skills to recharge it faster. So a lot of times it's just free DPS. Yeah.
Slingerman used to rave about this shield, and when he made his Sal Top Gear, that came at number one, and for a good reason. I mean, it's you're constantly getting shot at if you're playing Sal, so the shield will probably stay down for very long. And usually, if you're playing Sal, you're holding a Moxie weapon in your hand pretty much all the time.
Yep.
So as long as the Novas go off and hit something, you're staying topped off. To me, this is it's this great synergy. I personally don't use it because, like, I don't like the flashing lights and the shaking screen. Yeah. But if you can deal with that, you can do much worse than this. It's a really, really good choice.
Yep. And, yeah, that should cover shields. Grenades. Sal doesn't have a whole lot of grenade synergies other than being able to boost them 25% and throw two at once. But, I mean, the chain lightning is always an obvious choice. Just because...
you're holding a grog pretty much all the time.
Yeah, so it's an easy emergency button for him. It also just softens up enemies. It doesn't kill that well. Well, if you're throwing two of them at once, Sal probably does kill pretty well with it.
Yeah.
The Stormfront has some of the highest damage of a lot of grenades, but also has sustained healing because that Tesla effect stays out for a while in a very wide effect. So this
is actually my favorite grenade for Sal.
Okay.
If I'm let's say I haven't killed enough things to reset my cooldown completely with Get Some, and I'm out of Gunzerk, I will usually what I will do is switch to my grog as my main hand weapon and throw these around just to stay topped off until my Gunzerk comes back, because they last usually that's a only long a few time. Seconds.
Yeah.
Especially on the peak where those few seconds could be 10, 20 seconds. So it's as far as using grenades, because I usually don't use them that much, it's probably the best one for Sal, in my opinion, for general use.
Yep, that's fair enough. I mean, the Storm is just so good. It does so much damage in such a big area of effect for such a long duration. It's hard to compete with that. Tesla grenades are just good in general, but that one is insane. I brought the fastball because it just does a ton of damage, and if you can throw two of them, that's even crazier.
And it works awesomely with no kill like overkill.
Yeah.
Just toss it on a mob, and once it activates, just like fire on the big thing that you want to kill, and you'll probably always get that 400% bonus from no kill like overkill.
Yeah. Next, I brought magic missiles just to check out Slag. But I'm not the biggest fan of magic missiles personally, because they can act weird and target however they want. You can't always control them, and they can kill you with self-damage. And then the last reason because of it is the Slag explosion is so big, it can block your line of sight, a lot of visual pollution.
Of all the characters in the game, I think Sal gets the least out of this. It's still a very good Slag grenades, but usually Sal will have a Slag gun in his offhand, so it doesn't need to use that grenade slot for slagging. But if you're going with a Brawn build with two very powerful guns, one in each hand, and you want them both to match elements to increase the damage as much as you can, then this could be a great choice.
Yep. And the other choice for that would be the other grenade I brought, was a Slag Transfusion, which if you are doing a Brawn build, you might want, because when throwing out two of them, that's a lot of healing. They're going to still Slag pretty well. You can aim them better. You don't get the regen or as much damage, but you get less visual pollution. Just as much Slag, just about, and you just lose the regenning. So that's another good option.
Pretty solid, yeah.
That's all the grenades I brought. I mean, Sal can pretty much make any grenade pretty good just by chucking two of them. So, I mean, if you like a grenade, you can't really go wrong. I mean, like the Fire Bee or the Firestorm, I'm sure it would be a lot of fun.
Yeah, but anything that lasts for a long time and allows you to heal through moxie weapons is a good pick.
Then we have relics. I have the deputy's badge on me because obviously Sal, not only the deputy build, but Sal loves shotguns.
Yeah.
So that's really good. And with all of his special multiplicative skills like money shot and no kill like overkill, the base damage is a big deal.
Yeah. especially since it doesn't have a lot of base damage boost to his skills.
Next is Blood of the Ancients. This is health stacking, 62% max health on top of his other health stacking, and then a shield that boosts health.
Yeah, it's really kind of necessary if you want to do a Brawn build. Other than that, you would be unless you're dual wielding choppers, you probably will never run out of ammo if you do your build correctly. So the extra ammo from that is not necessary, but the health is.
Yep. The extra ammo, I mean, it's not necessary, but doesn't hurt. On some, it depends your build. Oh, well, ammo, cool. Not a big deal. Might of the Seraphs, you brought me up to bring this one, so...
Yeah, because of all the characters that can make melee builds, Sal is the only one to actually benefit from having a melee relic. The way the melee damage equation is made, it brings very little to either Zero or
Krieg
or even Gage if you want to get to with claws. But with Sal, most of what makes a melee Sal build work is dual wielding rapiers. But that damage bonus is placed elsewhere in the damage formula than the relic, so they kind of multiply each other, and it's the only time where this relic is worth it. Plus, it's got cooldown on the
Fistful of Hurt, which is a big deal.
Fistful of Hurt, exactly. So this is the only time and the only character where this relic makes sense. But it's if you're doing a melee build, then use this one.
Next is the Bone, because the elemental damage bonuses are huge. Sal doesn't actually need the cooldown so much most of the time, but on the peak and stuff, it does help.
Yep, it helps a bit. Yeah, I think Sal benefits the least from the bones of all the characters. Like, pretty much. He's pretty much the character that benefits the least from them.
Yeah,
but they're so amazingly good to start with. Then they're still a great choice.
I mean, if you want to go raid, it's gonna help you raid the fastest, probably.
Yeah.
Sheriff's badge, because Sal can do pistol builds, and again, the damage bonus is great. The fire rate is great.
It's one of the best relics in the game, in my opinion. If you're going pistols, use this. It's a no-brainer.
I had two Allegiance relics on me. I told you I didn't know why I had them. I was just probably playing around with some stuff. But I do have a Jacob's Allegiance relic, and if you want to do some weird, funky Jacob's builds, the recoil on this combined with...
The mag size?
Steady as she goes and the mag size. Well, you can hip-fire Jacob's really efficiently with Sal... with Steady as She Goes and a Jacob's Allegiance relic. So if you do want to do the Becca thing, which again is some weird thing that only I do, this can be a pretty big deal.
Or if you want to take out the Striker and turn it into a 12, 15 shot thing.
It can definitely do that. Yep. And even on the Striker, that recoil really helps on the Striker.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't know why I have a Bandit Allegiance relic on me. I really don't. But they're kind of cool, damage and fire rate. It's legit.
The thing is, with Sal, usually you're better off... With every other character, you're better off with a bone. But since Sal gets the least out of them, that's where Allegiance relics makes...
Hyperion ones are really good, too.
Yeah. So it's usually it was Allegiance relics are good, but... they're not as good as a bone, so I'm going to use a bone. Well, on Sal, it's much more open to debate.
Yeah.
The bone's probably better if you crunch the numbers, but it's much more...
When you remove the cooldown need out of it, I don't know if it is better. I think additive damage when he's got all his multiplicatives plus fire rate might outdo the element. I don't know. It really depends. But yeah, Allegiance Relics are fair game for sale, and they're fun. So fuck it, use some. I mean, that's a pretty good way to look at it. And that brings us to class mods. All right, so we're back for the class mods here. And like always, we'll start with the legendaries. And the first one, the legendary Berserker, because that was the first one in the game. Passes on this is cooldown, fire rate, and melee damage. The skills are lock and loaded, quick draw, filled to the brim, hard to kill, and insight. So it skips unconceivable. And it increases your movement speed while you're gunzerking, which I think is a really good red text ability on it. I mean, we've talked about movement speed enough. I don't love the melee damage on it, of course. I've done that ranting enough. But the skills, I think, are pretty good. I mean, Inconceivable doesn't need to be boosted, so that's not a big deal.
If Inconceivable was boosted, it would, in any way, shape, or form, it would break the game.
Yep.
I mean, it's just, there's no combat boost this skill, thankfully.
Yeah, and like some of these, like filled to the brim, you can just put 1 point in it. You don't need to boost that all the way.
Same with quick draw, and it's a good con in general, but it's completely outdone by many of them. This one's great if you're doing the melee build because you get increased movement speed to close on your target.
And the damage.
Increased melee damage, and you get the action skill cooldown rate is kind of nice because if you're doing a melee build, you're not shooting that much, so you might
need it.
So you might have to go to regular cooldown. Other than that, all the other legendary comms are so good that I'd be hard-pressed to recommend this one. All
right, that's fair enough. Actually, we'll do the Slayer next and just get rid of that. Yeah. All right, so the Slayer comm, burn damage, ignite chance, which once again, just dots. Max health, which is not good for health stacking because this does not get multiplied by anything that multiplies health. It's outside of the equation, which is dumb. And it boosts the exact same skills as the other comm we just covered, but only to
+4. The other one was good. The other one was good for the passives. And this one doesn't have the passives.
Yep.
So it's just like most of the Slayers come in Slayer come in this game. It's just, it's not good. It's just, yeah.
Yep.
That's pretty much where I stand on it. It's just thrown in the garbage. It's not worth it.
Do you have a order you want to do the legendaries in? Or does it matter?
Doesn't matter.
All right. So Hoarder is the first one in my backpack. The passives on the Hoarder are Team Bullet Regeneration plus 4.1, I think is the max. Unless I don't have a max one, not me. But that's an awesome team ability. I mean, everyone loves to have that. A lot of times I've played with sales where people are begging them to switch to the Hoarder when their build isn't a Hoarder. the skills locked and loaded, you know, solid skill. Lay Waste, which boosted, is pretty awesome. Five shots or six and filled to the brim. And then Insight.
This is my favorite one. I think of all comms, not just legendary comms, but of all comms. Because it does what it does so well. It's like it's a very focused thing. It five shots or six allow you to shoot forever. Locked and loaded. Increases your fire rate. Lay Waste increases your fire rate. Filter to Brim gives you more bullet to shoot with an increased fire rate. It's like, if you wanna play a bullet hose, this is the one. It does just about everything right.
Yeah, and then the purple version was Filled to the Brim, Lay Waste, and five shots or six.
It's still very good.
Yeah, but this one added Insight and
Locked and Loaded.
Insight and Locked
and Loaded. Those were not even necessary to add. So between the purple one and the legendary one, there's not a whole lot of difference. As long as you get at least 5 points in five shots or six to get that 50% chance for theoretical infinite mag, you'll be good. Even filter the brim is nice and all. Lay waste is great, so but it's still there on the purple. Even the blue one would be great.
The difference between the bullet regen isn't a ton, 3.8 to 4.1.
Yeah, it's barely noticeable in actual play.
Let me get rid of the other one. All right.
All in all, very, very solid choice.
Next would be the Gunzerker then. So this is cooldown rate, which again on sale isn't the best of boosts. But the skills, so again, lay waste is boosted on it. You have... Yeah. All in the reflexes, last longer, and yippee-ki-yay, and insight. So this is the permanent gunzerking one, right?
Yeah, exactly. Between last longer and yippee-ki-yay, you should be able to always be in gunzerk or always have a gunzerk at the ready. And the bonus to lay waste is just icing on the cake. That was Sludgeon's favorite, if I remember right. If you don't know what to use, this is a good choice.
Yep. And then the purple version of it isn't called the Gunzerker, it's called a Berserker. But they couldn't make this the Legendary Berserker because there already was one. And the skills added to this one, they both had yippee-ki-yay, let's see, all in the reflexes and insight.
Yeah, it's kind of like the same thing with the Hoarder. The purple one is just as good.
Yeah, I mean, insight's really awesome. I mean, insight to boosted insight is really good.
Yeah.
That's a lot of movement speed, that's so that's really awesome. All in the reflexes. I mean, that's...
Nah.
This thing boosted, though, that's a lot of fire rate. I mean, if you get 10 points...
If I'm using that, I'm usually dropping 1 point and then moving on. It's good, but it's not worth five. It's not worth four extra points.
Yeah, but I kind of do love those skills too. And I'm like, all right, I can just pop 1 point in this, get a lot of bonus, and not have to invest five. I kind of like that stuff sometimes on comms.
Yeah, don't forget insight also boosts reload speed. So it's kind of
that's a lot.
You got a lot of reload speeds. Yeah.
Yeah, which I think everyone loves a ton of reload speed. Legendary Titan, health regen per second, gun damage, and then minus shield capacity, which we talked about with the Rough Rider. The skills are hard to kill, out of bubblegum, I'm the Juggernaut, locked and loaded, and asbestos.
I've tried a lot of comms when I tried to make Brawn builds, and this one regularly came out on top. The only downside is, like we said, is the shield capacity penalty that prevents us from using the Rough Rider to get the most out of 10 out of 5 out of bubblegum. But other than that, a little bit more health regen, more power rate from out of bubblegum and locked and loaded, more health from hard to kill, which is it's a 20% more health than you would get from 5 out of 5, so it's kind of sizable. And as long as you're putting points into Brawn, you're not putting points into Gunlust to increase your damage in one way, shape, or form. So that extra gun damage is actually it's very interesting on that.
So I think
I like this one.
The purple version, I think, is conceptually cool designed. Except the minus shield capacity again. I mean, if you're doing a kind of a tanking con with some DPS help, why put that on there? I mean, I don't think the skills justify it. And the passive's health regen per second isn't that strong where you need to put negative shield capacity. But maybe that's to help I'm out of bubblegum and make that easier to proc. But the fact that they added asbestos and locked and loaded, I think that's where they went wrong in this one for the legendary. Like, so many of these legendaries I covered with so many characters were done so well, but really locked and loaded, it seems like a random, kind of easy choice. Oh, this is on a lot of comms. Let's put this in there.
It's a bit random, but then again, it's kind of a way to get some more fire rate without spending too much point in another tree.
Okay.
Where I would have changed the legendary one is I would not have added asbestos. I would have added Ain't Got Time to Bleed.
Yep.
That would have made it a great com. Really.
I mean, I would have almost even dropped Lock and Loaded and just go for Insight. Give you reload and crazy movement speed on top of all this health. I think that would have been a better move.
But if you're going down the Brawn Tree, you're going to put points into Insight, and you're going to put points into Buzz that can slow down anyway.
Yeah.
So it might have been overkill. And what you really want is more health regen, more ways to sustain damage,
yep,
and more ways to increase your damage output.
Like last longer, or I don't know. It seems like there's so many better skills that could have made.
Yeah, last longer added to that would have been.
Yeah,
it would have been better.
And that's only tier two. You're probably going to get it anyways. I don't know. It just seems like there'd be so many better choices than the two that they picked.
Agreed.
And not to go back to Maya too many times, but like all the Maya ones that they added to the game were almost all perfectly designed.
Yeah.
You know, the binder, yeah, the skills they added to that, the nurse com, the cat com going pure DPS, and this one just... Especially because that skill tree was already suffering when these came out, so like they really needed to nail this class mod, and they didn't.
Yeah. They're 2 out of 3 for the new legendaries. This one's it's good, but it could have been great with just minor changes.
Yep. It's close. Oh, well.
Just like all things in the Brawn Tree, it's close.
Yep. Is there an order you want to do with the other ones?
Yeah. Go ahead.
All right. So first one I have up in the backpack is the radar com. Assault rifle accuracy plus 51% and then negative shield capacity. I don't really get this.
Neither do I.
Now it boosts money shot, which is awesome because money shot is awesome. It boosts locked and loaded and it boosts insight. So skill wise, it's pretty good. But yeah, get a blue one. Which one would you go for your second one with blue?
Oh, Insight.
Yeah.
Definitely. Locked and Loaded is... I don't know. It's
okay, but...
If you're relying on money shots, then you might be using, like, a deputy build, or you, and fire rate would not be that interesting, but... I don't know. They're both interesting, but...
And this has sadly been made kind of useless with the Chaotic Evil, or the Monk.
Yeah. The Monk is better overall. Yeah. Yeah,
because it's got better passives, it still hits Money Shot. But if you can't get to that Monk and the Monk's a bitch to farm, this is a good replacement.
Or if you're using the Tortoise and you need the shield capacity penalty.
Yeah. Yep.
I really don't get the assault rifle accuracy bonus on that, though.
It's random.
It seems like they rolled dice on a table and says, well, that's what this one gets.
And the shield capacity thing is dumb. I mean, it comes in handy because of Fabled Tortoise kind of thing, but it's still kind of dumb. But that lets you run really fast. Next one, I have the tank. And that's shield capacity and recharge rate. And skills are Hard to Kill, Asbestos, and I'm the Juggernaut.
I don't think Sal is in these comms that is worse than that. I mean,
it does nothing to your DPS.
So you increase your health and resist, but then you go and increase shield capacity. When it's which one you're trying to achieve here? Yep. I know it makes you kind of tanky, but just look at the Titan that we just did. It also has I'm the Juggernaut. It also has Hard to Kill, but instead of Asbestos, it has Auto Bubble Gum and a Gun Damage Boost and Health Regen. It's I don't know. I don't understand it. It's oh well.
Doesn't quite make sense.
Nah.
Next is the War Dog. Reload speed and magazine size, 2 good passives. Out of bubblegum, 5 shots and 6, and filled to the brim. I like this a lot.
This one is the most underrated comms in for Sal. I love it, I haven't seen anyone ever use it, and I don't get why. It's really, really good.
I kind of want to make a butcher build with this.
And you could. It usually for 5 shots or 6, you're trying to get 10 out of 5 to get 50% chance to get in, like, theoretical infinite mag. But with a blue one, you can get 11 out of 5 and actually be able to sustain fire. Like, you'll get... If your kill skills are active, you'll get more bullets than you spend. Plus, out of bubble gun, that gives you an incredible fire rate.
Yep.
And reload speed and mag size. It's just... There's nothing wrong with that combo. It's one of the best ones in the game. And
all right, so maybe I have a sale video coming up. The butcher sale.
Yeah, you can try. The real problem with the War Dog is that the Legendary Hoarder does just about everything this one does, but slightly better.
Yeah, but this looks fun. And reload a mag. Like, you can get that mag size huge with this. And on the Butcher, yeah, everything you add to the mag size is a big deal.
I've used it with the longbow, because... the ammo regen is not necessary because it doesn't shoot that fast, and you already have a basic ammo regen with Gunzerking, and increasing that mag size and fire rate and it worked great.
Hmm. Yeah, I'm gonna play with this. I don't often do sales stuff, but my love for the Butcher probably. Yeah. It's just this when I was adding things to it, I'm like, holy crap, this is the perfect Butcher comm.
Yeah. The thing is, it doesn't restrict you to any kind of gun.
Yep.
It's very
very neutral.
Yeah.
All right. So the next one in the backpack is the Devastator, which is team magazine size, which is generally pretty nice too. Decent team boost. Not the best of them, but Divergent Likeness, filled to the brim, and just got real.
Yeah.
It seems really random.
It is, and it's one of those that I don't like. It's the team, the co-op bonus is it's okay, I guess. I think the best way to take advantage of it would be one that boosts Divergent Likeness as high as possible to get that damage boost. But I'm
just got real kind of a waste, so I'd go with a blue one probably.
Yeah,
filled to the brim. Filled to the brim, you can get a massive magazine size with that and the class mod.
I'm trying to find ways to make this interesting, like, because what it offers is mag size and a bit of damage boost, but it's not enough.
Yeah.
If you consider,
because sales got other ways to make things shoot forever.
Yeah,
that do it better.
Exactly.
Than this.
It's not that one's that one's not very good.
Yeah. Next is his pistol comm, the Renegade. So gun damage.
I love that one.
Yeah, pistol gun damage, great. Minus accuracy. Here's the weird thing is.
It's barely noticeable.
Well, it's barely noticeable, but like Maya's got the minus accuracy on her SMG one, but then she's got a massive gun boost because of it. This one, the gun damage isn't that big.
Yeah,
but
probably because pistols, there are pistols that are more damaging than even the most damaging SMG.
Yeah.
So,
but it does boost Ymir Huckleberry, which makes a lot of sense.
Mm-hmm.
It boosts All I Need Is One. Which I don't know if I like. And it boosts insight, which is always nice. But pistols don't really need that reload.
Yeah.
This should boost a divergent likeness and go with two pistols.
Instead of All I Need Is One?
Yeah.
You mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, that would have been great. That would have yeah. Same tree. That would have made a lot of sense.
You want a dual wield pistols, and if you had I'm Your Huckleberry likeness and the Sheriff's badge, like that's something.
Yeah. Or it could have boosted Locked and Loaded and would have made a lot of sense too, because they're all both in the same tree. And Locked and Loaded activates whenever you reload a gun. whichever gun it is. So if you're holding two, then yeah, you can cycle that bonus if your guns are on time.
Fuck, I should have just boosted to all three of those. Locked and loaded, I'm your Huckleberry Divergent likeness. Bam. Perfect pistol comm. And you're just going that straight been awesome. Down. And it's still not bad, but it could have been cooler.
It's actually one of my favorites because Salvador can get a lot of gun damage bonuses, but that one that's I don't know what's the max stat on that. It's like something like
53. I think I have max stats here.
Yeah, 53 something. It's actually as much as you can probably get out of Sal. I mean, you can get 30% out of Divergent Likeness, 15% out of Amiral Colberry, and that comes up to about, so you kind of double your gun damage bonuses with that. It's, I don't know, if you're using pistols but don't rely on money shot chains, like you're using a Vlad of Anarchist, this is probably the best comm you can use. You see?
Yeah, I see that.
Because you have so many fire rate boosts, and what you really need to up the damage is more gun damage bonuses, and this one provides that.
See, everyone listening, that was a great point by him. Everyone goes, when you got fast things, you just want to get more fast. But no, when you have fast things, you want to counteract that with damage.
Yeah, they're kind of damage, you want to counteract
that with fire rate. Yep. Next, we've got the Beast, max health and reload speed, and then Sexual Tyrannosaurus just got real and insight. I don't really like this.
I like it when leveling up.
Okay.
When I'm in normal mode and starting True Vault Hunter mode, the max health bonus is interesting, coupled with T-Rex, that gives you a reasonable amount of
health regen. Be before the percentages and get boosted by them. That always makes me mad. I got to get over that.
Instead of boosting, just got real. If it boosted, like ain't got time to bleed, or
yeah,
or even hard to kill, that would have been great.
It's been a better fucking comm.
It's okay. It's just in middle of the road, but it's kind of decent when you're leveling up.
Yeah, it's not terrible or anything. It's just not great. And that leaves us with the monks. I actually only had a blue one instead of a purple one. So these, you know, all the passives, you can get critical hit, fire rate, accuracy, reload speed, magazine size. Is that the five different buffs you can mix and match?
Accuracy, fire rate, critical hit damage, reload speed, and mag size. Right.
Yep. And the skills on this is Money Shot, Asbestos, and what's the third skill?
T-Rex.
Okay. That's why I have Asbestos on it. So, I mean, Money Shot and the passives are the real thing here. You want a blue one, and then you pick. Yeah. I think money a lot of people go with Asbestos because they're not going down that far to get to Sexual Tyrannosaurus. Yeah.
Depending on your build, because
it's a better skill.
Yeah. I personally use my Deputy build with... I put a lot of points in Brawn.
Okay.
Because... You don't really need. There's so many things that don't work with a deputy build.
Yeah. Like
fire rate buff is wasted. So you kind of after 60 points spent, you kind of have to go, well, where can I put these to not waste them too much? Yep. So I kind of go down the Brawn Tree to get bust that can slow down, and at that point it's not a big stretch to put points into T-Rex.
Okay. But yeah, the second one, depending on your build, it depends. But yeah, this thing is the main thing. It's Money Shot. And now the passives on these, which ones of these passives work in the offhand?
Crit bonus.
Is that the only one?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. So a lot of people, like Chaotic Evil is kind of the go-to for a lot of people, but you know, if you're doing the deputy, the fire rate's obviously wasted. Not only doesn't apply, but who cares?
But I personally guess... use a neutral evil.
Okay.
And that helps.
I forget the names.
It helps when I switch to my rocket launcher and pimp, so I don't have to change comm. But as long as you have evil in it, you get pretty much all the bonuses you can want.
Yeah. So yeah, that's all of Sal's class mods. That's everything. We've done it all, and I think this is maybe the longest one yet. So we're probably pushing 3 hours. is there any thing you want to say for wrapping up here?
No, I think we pretty much covered it.
Hopefully.
3 hours. No, that's pretty much it. That's pretty much it.
All right, everyone. Yep. Thanks for watching. This is Chuck. If you're wondering too, if he has an accent, he is from French Canada, right? Or some people call it Canada. I call it Canada because I'm a disrespectful American. But yeah, and Chuck wasn't with me in game because he does not have a PC to run the game. He's on console. So that's why he's just on mic. I could have said that at the beginning of the video. So anyways, go check out his forum stuff. If you aren't familiar with Chuck, I'll put a link to his forum profile so you can go and find his threads and posts and all that stuff, because Chuck has done a lot of awesome work. And if you guys love Sal, you should definitely enjoy reading Chuck's contributions to this game. And yeah, that's all I got. So you guys know where to find me, you know, my Twitter, Facebook, all that stuff. As always, like and subscribe if you have not done that so far, and all that outro bullshit I'm sick of saying. So, see you all later. Thanks for sitting through this. If you made it to the end, I should probably get you a cookie. Bye.
Bye.